in the drought-parched foothills of San Bernardino County grew from 500 acres to 3,500 acres in a matter of hours. U.S. Forest spokeswoman Lynn Silliette said it held that footprint through Sunday, dampened by a day of light rainfall on Saturday. Fire crews were hoping for more rainfall as they worked to expand the containment lines around the rest of the fire perimeter. Officials lifted all evacuation orders and road closures on Saturday evening, and people were returning to the communities of Baldy Mesa and Oak Hills, California. On Friday, the blaze ripped down a portion of Interstate 15 that links Southern California and Las Vegas, forcing 60 drivers to abandon their cars and scramble to safety. 18 cars and two tractor trailers were destroyed, along with 11 homes and outbuildings. A separate 200-acre wildfire northwest of San Bernardino, which triggered evacuations of several campgrounds on Saturday, was 40% contained, and evacuation orders had been lifted on Sunday. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Researchers at Princeton University's Department of Sociology have made a major leap in our understanding of social interaction.
We conducted trials in 90 supermarkets across the country and found that essentially 100% of people disapproved of having a stranger hit them across the face and then expose their genitalia right in the middle of the supermarket, which we found very interesting.
Researchers observed similar reactions when the subject hurled shopping carts toward unsuspecting shoppers, stood in the deli section rubbing cold cuts against his chest, or got right near cashier's ears and began loudly singing Yankee Doodle.
In this particular trial, we had our subject, Kevin, take off his shirt, tape a banana to his forehead, and charge at various shoppers like he was a rhino. Within 20 minutes, store owners called the police and he was arrested, allowing us to come to the conclusion that this type of behavior is still considered at least somewhat taboo.
This is the Onion News Network.
Welcome to Free Talk Live. Of course, you can bring up anything you want. However, tonight, you'll have to do it via Skype. I've been talking about it over the last few shows that we're going to do a little experimental radio here this evening. It's important to change things up a little bit every now and then. And we've never done a Skype-only show. There have been times where a set of phone lines has been out because of technical difficulties. Our network studios, for instance, are in Minnesota, and every now and then the phone lines go down. But in that case,
that's not the case today.
That's not the case today. But also in that case, we always have phone lines here in our studio as well. So it's almost never. In fact, it has never happened to where GCN, our network's lines, and our lines have gone down. So we've always had a phone option on Free Talk Live. At least certainly in recent years.
Not always a toll-free number, but most people seem to have, you don't hear people talking about long distance as much as they did maybe 20 years ago.
Right. So tonight we're going to do things a little differently. I'm sure I'll probably at some point accidentally give the phone lines out. I have requested my co-hosts to give me a verbal lashing at that time if I do it. So I need to just give out the Skype username, because that's the only way you'll be able to connect with the show tonight. Skype username is lrn.fm. Ian and Mark are in the studio as normal, and our third co-host is usually Derek J. He, however, is in San Francisco on what is likely a super
gay. With flowers in his hair.
Yeah, a super gay vacation for Derek. So please, we have Renee Kate with us here tonight. Welcome.
Oh, hey.
So Renee is the host of one of the hosts of Seditious Sirens, which is a filthy show as far as the language that comes out of her mouth on LRN.FM. She will not be able to use any of those words.
I know.
Many of them here tonight. So
get that dump button up.
Yeah, it'll be very challenging for Renee. So coming up, we'll talk about senior citizens and the crackdown that's happening on them in Indiana. Apparently, some elderly folks have been playing Euchre. And this is a card game from the 1860s. And there's some level of money involved in this Euchre. At least in this case, there are prizes. And the police don't like that very much. So we'll talk about the crackdown that's happening there. Plus, one general says, Mark, you've got this story. One general says that drones create terrorists. And another general is saying that people who are disloyal to the United States, within the United States, should be locked up in camps. We got the audio of that.
Yeah, we have it's an evening of sort of articles that give you know, people that shouldn't be getting the kind of attention that they do, all kinds of extra attention. I mean, what do I care what a general says? But
well, this one general, at least, that is saying lock people up in camps, said that on national television.
Yep. As well. Well, the other general, when he says that drones, he's a former Defense Intelligence Agency general, and when he says that drones create more terrorism, I think he has more weight. What a general has to say about civilians' patriotism, well, frankly, he can kiss my butt.
All right, we'll get into all that. Of course, if you want to comment, jump in here at the Skype username. I've got to stop myself from the phone number. Skype username, lrn.fm. The thing you have to do is send a contact request first. We'll approve it. You'll be good to go to call us from that point forward. So let's jump into the story because we teased this last night. Senior citizens under attack in Indiana. The story from thestarpress.com, where 2 or 3 days a week, 88-year-old Berelda is her name, Berelda, B-E-R-Y-L-D-A, Berelda Wilson and her friends get together to play euchre. Now, I gotta say, I have never played euchre. Have either of you ever had an experience with this game?
Never heard of it.
I've heard of it, and I know people play it, but I think it's a Trump-based game. I just don't know anything else.
I looked briefly at it on Wikipedia. It has to do with tricks. A trick-based game. I'm not sure what that means. Normally, the word trick is associated with prostitution.
No, it's usually associated with card games. It's just that you live in a real weird world.
So, apparently, according to the story here at the Star Press, because these elderly folks pay a couple of bucks to play the game, and they take home prizes like packs of cookies or toilet paper.
Well, that's crazy. Crazy talk.
Right.
They are breaking Indiana law, and they must be stopped. Mm. Now, I added those last few words in, but they are breaking Indiana law, and the story says state officials have ordered an end to the illegal gambling. The Indiana Gaming Commission last week contacted officials of the Senior Center, where the most common regular activities besides euchre include bridge, that's also a card game, and line dancing, and told them the pay-for-play must stop. Senior Center officials scrambled to comply and notified the 50 or so euchre players that the days of Vegas on West 8th Street were over.
Hmm.
Center officials are worried about the potential loss of rent from the euchre players, but players like Wilson and her daughter are left shaking their heads. Her daughter says, quote, it gives them some excitement, unquote. In other words, Wilson and her fellow euchre players aren't in it for the canned peaches that have been offered as prizes. The law is the law, however, says the article, and Indiana law says
it sounds like joke prizes. I mean, we're talking about toilet paper and canned peaches here.
Well, who doesn't need toilet paper and canned peaches?
Well,
these are important prizes.
I think just about everybody needs toilet paper. Canned peaches, you could go either way on those, man.
Yeah, that's true. Indiana law
says,
I
just feed them to the pigs.
Card games like poker and euchre are considered gambling if played for money. Delaware County Prosecutor Jeffrey Arnold said that this is a real story. This is actually happening, said that he was unaware of the Gaming Commission's contact with the Senior Center, saying that I haven't heard a thing about this. I hope there's a way they can get the proper license to continue to play. Now, in some states, you can have like a charitable gambling thing. Like here in New Hampshire, I mean, obviously in other states it's
bingo,
legal
right?
to have gambling, but here in New Hampshire, they actually have card rooms where you can go and get dealt a hand of poker and actually play for money. But like half of the winnings, I believe, goes to some sort of charity. I've never been to one of these poker rooms, but I know a number of people who have attended them. And that's my understanding of how it works. But each one of these rooms essentially is, I don't know if it's run as a nonprofit, but it might be. At the very least, they are benefiting a nonprofit, typically,
okay,
with the benefits from the game. So maybe that's what the cop is suggesting here, or rather the county prosecutor is suggesting, that they should get one of these charitable permits or something like that. He says, I don't consider that to be real egregious when asked about the euchre games. This is the prosecutor again. For a couple of decades now, local senior citizens have been playing bingo and cards at the center. The former Forest Park School senior director Judy Elton said the center's former classrooms and other spaces are home to a church. There's a baker who uses their kitchen equipment, yoga and line dancing devotees, as well as the senior card players. Now, do you think that these elderly folks are just going to give it up, or is euchre going to go into the underground at the Senior Center?
Well, I hope not.
You hope that it won't go underground, or do you hope that it will?
Oh, well, I mean, I hope that it will go underground. When you're above a certain age, you tend to be stuck in your ways, so to say. So hopefully they just continue to do whatever they want.
Well, I certainly hope so. I mean, I wonder how many of these people were around during Prohibition.
Well, the Senior Center, it may be a, you know, it's like a quasi-governmental agency, isn't it? I mean, the expectation is that people...
yeah, that's a good point. It might be.
So I'm suspecting that the folks that run it are the ones that you're going to have to watch out for on this. I think that the people that go there are liable to say, yeah, whatever. Put me away, copper.
Well, that is true, because it does point out here that they are worried about, the administrators are worried about losing the card players, as far as, you know, if they can't play Euchre for a little bit of money or whatever, these canned peaches, that they won't come back to the Senior Center. And that's certainly possible. I mean, they could go and play card games at one of their assisted living facilities or their homes or
their
wherever
house,
they
right?
live.
Yeah, I would think that that would be the case. You know, that'd be my first thought. Well, the Euchre game will be at my place. Anybody can come over.
For a facility with only two full-time employees, the center sees a few thousand people come through its doors in a month. Not all of those users are of the same law-breaking bent as the Euchre players. The way Euchre works at the Senior Center is simple. Players pay $2.50 to play. About $1 of that goes to the center. And the Euchre Club gives us a part of what they take in, says the executive director.
There. And they give a part.
That's correct.
Okay.
That's usually about $30 for a three-hour session. We're not talking about a great deal of money here.
No, we
says.
Sure aren't.
She was surprised to be contacted by the Indiana Gaming Commission on July 13th.
Because it's stupid.
Saying that someone called the state and was concerned if you want to pay to, or if you pay to play and win prizes, that's considered gambling. We thought that that only applied to cash prizes. That's why they had the peaches and things like that. So if you actually support the crackdown on these people, because apparently the Indiana Gaming Commission does, I would love to hear from you, but you gotta call us on Skype. Skype username tonight is lrn.fm. Coming up, generals have very different things to say about terrorism. It's Free Talk Live. We're coming up.
I'm Steve Sitkowski, a former Wall Street insider. I'm holding a book that will show you investing strategies which could help you earn the kind of money you've always dreamed about. And right now, I'm giving this book away for free. So who needs to read it? If you're in the middle of your career and worry you'll never have enough money to retire, you need to read this book. If you're already retired and your income isn't enough, you need to read this book. And if you don't want to be selling burgers at 80, you need to read this free book. It includes the strategy I use to make a 72% profit on a trade where the stock only moved 12%. You'll need at least $1 million to ever fully retire. If you're behind on that goal, you really need to read Trade Like the Pros. And you can for free by calling 1-800-944-5836. Skeptical that it will deliver results? It's a free book, so what do you have to lose? Find out how at 1-800-944-5836. 1-800-944-5836.
Hi, this is Steve Spillum for Midas Resources. In 1971, President Nixon took the United States off the gold standard and put us into a fiat currency. This allowed Congress and the Federal Reserve to create trillions of dollars out of thin air. The national debt has risen to incredible heights, and your hard-earned dollars buy a small fraction of what they once did. The average life expectancy for a fiat currency is 27 years. The dollar is failing and on borrowed time. When currencies fall, people turn to gold and silver because gold and silver have been real money for more than 5,000 years. It is our mission at Midas Resources to help you preserve your capital. Don't let your personal savings shrink to nothing. For important free information on how you can protect your personal wealth, contact me, Steve Spillum, at 1-800-686-2237, extension 308. Call today while we are still accepting dollars for gold and silver. 1-800-686-2237, extension 308. Make a change in your financial security today. That's 1-800-686-2237, extension 308.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project, and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. You can help by joining the AMP program for just $5 a month at amp.freetalklive.com and getting perks. That's amp.freetalklive.com. If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
If worst comes to worst, will you be prepared? You don't have to be a survivalist to prepare for the unexpected. Storing necessary supplies like food, water, and emergency equipment is simply taking responsibility for ourselves and our families when it counts the most. StrategicShelters.com offers emergency supplies and a secure way to store them, and provides protection for loved ones in the event of an extreme natural or man-made disaster. To find out more, visit StrategicShelters.com.
Help get LRN.FM into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm for a free bumper sticker, flyers, banners, graphics, and more. Promote.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live, and you can join us here via Skype. Skype is username lrn.fm. That allows you to connect with us here tonight. We're not doing toll-free lines tonight, just as an experiment, and we've already got a Skype call on the line. So we'll get into
why
that.
Why do you hate phones, Ian?
Here in a moment. I just, you know, the phones are less than desirable to me, and I want to see if we can hold a show together with Skype. I think it'll be fine, given that, you know, sometimes we don't have any calls anyway. So here we sorry about that. We got Renee with us here.
Yeah. Wait, are you considering actually taking away the phone lines?
No, I'm not. No.
Okay, I was going to say.
But I want the network to, I want to work with the network and try to improve the quality of those phone lines, because I've been frustrated.
He is, he's really picky about sound quality, and the phones just don't make him happy. So this is, I don't know what this is other than it's just an idea.
Okay.
I will not be for getting rid of the phone.
Because there's a phone in your logo, for crying out loud.
Yeah, that's true.
Right,
that's
it's not a Skype logo.
Hey, it's just one night. We're just experimenting.
We still have phones in
the
logo?
It's fun to experiment. Yes, at freetalklive.com. You can go see our logo anytime, Mark. Go check that out.
Oh, that one, yeah.
All right, so...
Do you remember the old one with the guy screaming into the phone?
Yeah, that's an old logo. So anyway, by the way, welcome to Forks Talk, KBDB HD3 on 96.7. We're actually on an HD-only channel in Forks, Washington. So
sweet.
Welcome aboard. If you are listening to us there, then you have to have an HD radio, which not very many people have. So it's an elite group of listeners in Forks. Welcome aboard. We're live, by the way, every single night, weeknights. So we are actually the afternoon drive show in Forks, Washington, which is right up the very, like, almost the most northwestern city, if you want to even call it that, town, the northwestern town in the United States, basically.
So we're hitting, like, Vancouver and stuff, too?
Not quite. There's, like, Victoria, which is to the slight west of Vancouver. Okay. So, yeah. So join us here. Our Skype username is lrn.fm, and let's go right into your calls and thoughts. First, Benjamin is on the line in California. Benjamin, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian, Renee, and Mark.
Good evening. I am happy to be part of this Skype experiment. I think it's a good idea.
Okay, great.
The other day, Ian, you offhandedly mentioned you guys were talking about government spying on people, and you mentioned how something about, didn't the KGB used to do that to people? And I wanted to recommend my favorite foreign film, which is called The Lives of Others. And it actually is dealing with East Germany in the 80s. It wasn't that long ago, because in Germany, they actually did this. There was a group called the Stasi. They were the secret police, and they monitored people and collected their information and just did all sorts of horrible, awful things. And I just think it'd be a good thing for people to watch and go, oh, yeah, that wasn't that long ago. And it was in a Western country. It wasn't, some weird place that was doing this.
I don't know if East Germany is really considered the West. I think that that's like the start of the East.
Sure. Either way, it wasn't some podunk weird country somewhere. It was...
relatively modern wall up. I mean, they're pretty weird, but I think that I think your point is correct that the United States is beginning to look more and more like, sadly, like East Germany. I don't think anybody wants to admit it, but you know that that air flight. It seems like every airplane flight takes off from East Berlin. You know, you got to get the blue glove love. You got to get checked. You know, you got to talk to their little chatty TSA agent officer there, and then yeah, I mean it ain't so great.
So I would just highly recommend people watch that. I think it's a fantastic film.
One more time, the name was what?
It's called The Lives of Others.
The Lives of Others, and it's a foreign film?
So it's a subtitles? Foreign film. Yeah, there's subtitles, but... You know,
excellent.
If you can't handle subtitles, I guess don't watch it. But I think it's an important enough film, and it's really good.
All right. Thanks for the recommendation. What else do you want to share tonight? Go ahead.
The other thing was, you guys have two advertisers, and I think they both pair well together, and I would like to recommend how people could use them, and that is... go and buy $40 of Bitcoin using ExpressCoin. Just $40.
Because there's no transfer fee when you use code FTL on up to $40.
Yeah. Just get $40. It's not a lot. You're not going to break the bank, hopefully, with that. And then use that $40 to make a couple of small purchases on purse.io. I know I started using it a couple months ago before they were an advertiser. And I was like, I don't know how it's going to work. And so I just made some small purchases of like books just to kind of test it out. And it worked beautifully. It was fantastic. And Purse has a little bit of a kind of a reputation system kind of thing built in. I'm not exactly sure how that works.
It's just but a smiley face and a frowny face or like a mid face. So you can rate
and
people.
And they give you rankings or whatever.
Yeah.
And so if you just make a couple small purchases just to give it a taste, and then that builds your reputation. You can see how it works. So anyways, my recommendation is buy $40 in Bitcoin and then make a couple of small purchases on purse.io.
What you want to do is use purse.freetalklive.com, because if you go to purse.freetalklive.com, then a very small portion of each purchase will go towards Free Talk Live. So if you don't sign up under that, then that won't happen.
The purse keeps it.
Yeah, please go to purse.freetalklive.com.
What did you buy something doing it this way, and what was the savings you got?
Oh, I just made a couple small purchases. They were just books, so I've only saved a few dollars.
But what was the percentage that you got off?
Oh, I saved 20%
That's pretty good. Off a small item, that all adds up over time, and it makes a big difference.
That's why I say this is a raise. You can buy just about everything you need in life through Amazon, and when you start using the method that Benjamin's just outlined here, you can begin. It's like getting a small raise in your life.
Yeah, it's a killer app for Bitcoin. Thanks for the recommendation tonight, Benjamin. Appreciate hearing from you. And once again, go to purse.freetalklive.com. 20%, 25%, 29% is what I got off of these headphones that I'm wearing here in the studio. All because I'm paying with Bitcoin through purse.freetalklive.com. So Mark was shouting at me during the break, and he's wondering if he wanted to know if we could talk about this on the air. I said, sure, if you want to talk about this on the air, that's fine. He's upset that I had not informed him in advance that Chris Cantwell was going to be on the show.
Oh boy, grab your popcorn, kids.
Yeah. I had told you on actually 2 months in advance that Chris Cantwell was going to be subbing for you, because you gave me a lot of notice that you were attending a awards ceremony last night. You were actually there with Daryl, and Dr. Mary Ruart spoke, and we're actually going to have her on the show, hopefully as a guest here within about a week.
Right, I emceed the New Hampshire Liberty Alliance's Liberty Dinner, and it was a great event. And you may or may not have informed me that Cantwell was going to sit in for me, but... in the meantime, right?
Yeah.
Like, there was an incident where, there was, Cantwell posted some things on his on his Twitter that, like radio talk show hosts get fired over. And I was concerned for the well-being of Free Talk Live. So I said, I'm not going to come in if you have Cantwell on.
Right. And so we agreed to indefinitely suspend him.
That's correct.
And I decided to end that indefinite suspension without consulting you first.
And I think I'm at this point looking at the reaction on the Facebook page, I'm not going to have a particular problem with your decision to unsuspend him, okay?
Well, that's good, because forgiveness is important, as Cantwell and I discussed last night. And And Chris is not a bad guy. And
I didn't get to hear the show, so I mean, I couldn't speak to it entirely. What you said, I was busy doing emceeing and that sort of thing. And that's not my problem. My problem is you choosing to go behind your business partner's back, and
having a surprise party is not going behind someone's back. We're going to come back with more here.
Surprise parties are good, and quit acting.
This was good. It was good radio. 855-450-free. Oh, you're right. Thank you. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. You can join us here on Free Talk Live. No phone lines tonight.
You are an individual with your own thoughts, decisions, and actions. So why should you be penalized for not enrolling in the subpar health insurance mandated by the government when you can be truly independent with Liberty HealthShare, a bold, innovative alternative allowing you to take back control and make your own decisions about your health care? Mention this ad when you call to learn more. 800-714-6993. That's 800-714-6993. Liberty HealthShare. Together, we are one.
We use mobile devices right against our bodies every day, but growing scientific evidence has emerged showing serious health risks associated with exposure to EMF radiation emitted from these devices. The solution is Defender Shield, the most effective mobile radiation shielding ever developed. Defender Shield blocks virtually 100% of EMF radiation from cell phones, tablets, and laptops, and starts at just $64.99. Buy now at DefenderShield.com. For 10% off, use promo code GCN. DefenderShield.com, the worldwide leader in mobile radiation shielding.
Keenvention is coming up October 30th through November 1st. Get your tickets now at keenvention.info. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. Explore Keen, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, do some Robin Hooding, and learn about making the move. Visit keenvention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel from 2013 on. This year, Activist of the Year Daryl W. Perry and Chris Cantwell will be keynoting. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenvention this October 30th through November 1st. Only 100 tickets are available in advance, so lock yours in now for just $60 or pay with Bitcoin. That includes access to the Hallo Keene Costume Dance Party. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more speaker announcements or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info. keenvention.info. So you've signed the Shire Society Declaration and are planning your move to New Hampshire to be around more liberty-oriented people. Next, sign up for the Shire Society Forum at forum.shiresociety.com. There are a bunch of people there who are already in the Shire, and they want to meet you. If you're already in the Shire physically, you should also come by the forums. Remember, not everyone uses Facebook. New people are signing up for the Shire Society Forum every month, so drop in and say hello at forum.shiresociety.com.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's posts pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. facebook.freetalklive.com.
Cato University is the Cato Institute's premier educational event of the year. It's being held this year from July the 26th to the 31st at the Cato Institute's state-of-the-art headquarters in Washington, D.C. This annual program brings together outstanding faculty and participants from across the country and often from around the globe, with everyone sharing a commitment to liberty and learning. Cato University is a genuine community, and you can freely share viewpoints, concerns, ideas, questions, and more in an atmosphere of friendship and personal respect. It's a one-of-a-kind program for people who don't stop thinking after they got out of school. It's for people who don't want politicians or bureaucrats or officials to do their thinking for them. It's for people who value liberty. You'll learn, you'll be inspired, you'll make new friends, you'll meet great people from around the world. All of the details are spelled out at the Cato website, cato.org, and they hope to see you there this summer, July the 26th through the 31st in Washington, D.C. Again, details are at cato.org.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at lrn.fm.
We'll be right back.
This is Free Talk Live. You cannot dial in toll-free tonight, but you can join us toll-free on Skype because there aren't tolls on Skype. I guess you can pay for a paid Skype account, but you really don't have to. It doesn't increase your call quality, at least that I know of. So you can join us here. Skype username is lrn.fm. And as Benjamin called in the last segment, ExpressCoin is really a great choice for getting Bitcoin, as well as Litecoin and Dogecoin. It's fast, safe, easy, and inexpensive. And as was pointed out, you can save on up to $40 worth of cryptocurrency by paying no transfer fee when you use code FTL. Now, if you go above $40, then it's just a mere 3%, which is really a great deal for getting Bitcoin. And once again, ExpressCoin.com. You can do it from your smartphone, whether in the U.S. or Canada. That's ExpressCoin.com. Go there and get your cryptocurrencies with money order or check. And once again, it's ExpressCoin.com with coupon code FTL, like Free Talk Live. With you tonight, it's me, Ian.
Renee.
And Mark.
And Renee here, courtesy of the Seditious Sirens. You guys have a Facebook page, right, Renee?
Yep.
Is there a website yet? Not yet, right?
Well, we're working on it.
Working real hard, I bet.
They don't call me Renee late for nothing.
You know, at least you own it, and I appreciate that. So, Seditious Sirens, look for them on Facebook. Hit the like button.
Yeah, or you could go to seditioussirens.com, which will bring you to our Facebook page.
It's like 2 hours of complaining every single week.
Well, when I do it with Cody O'Connor, because Anne is taking a break right now, it is 2 hours of complaining. But, I mean, otherwise, it's 2 hours of pure bliss and sexiness. It's wonderful.
Yeah, check them out. All right, so our toll-free number. Our contact method tonight is Skype. Username is lrn.fm. Mark, would you like to continue haranguing me for not giving you notice about the programming decision
last
night?
Do it.
It's not my intention to harangue you, Ian. Okay. It's my intention to drive home a point.
You want me to feel bad? I have felt bad. I mean, I knew that a little. I do. I feel a little bad that Mark got so upset about it.
That's the tease.
No. Okay, if this is you teasing me, you need to learn how to properly tease people. And so I'm attempting to have a little intervention with you.
Uh-huh.
Right? Like you're standing there smiling right now.
It was really, I wanted to screw with you a little bit. I mean, that's
smug.
What it was.
Right.
He is smug.
Right. So this is it. This is what it comes down to. He can't find a joke as good as King Mark the First, right? Like I've got this whole King
that's
Mark the First
funny.
Thing going on. And it bothers him. He's like a king, but I'm a voluntarist.
Really
no kings
me.
Here. And he's trying
it
to come up
funny,
with something funny,
but not that funny.
Right. He's trying to come up with something funny, and this is his idea of a joke. And
it's a little prank. That's all.
There
has to be a victim of a prank.
I agree. There do have to be victims of pranks. Not funny.
Okay.
Okay.
All right. Fair enough.
Unacceptable joke.
All right. Well, it's done, and it's over. So,
yeah, so I think people are probably wondering if Cantwell's going to be back on a regular basis.
No, I would say it would be an irregular basis at this point. So
that's too bad.
He was in filling in. Well, we've already found Taryn Lupo, who's taken over this Wednesday show, and he's great. Conan is on Tuesday nights, and he's been doing great, too. So it wouldn't be right for me to go in there and boot either of those two gentlemen out and make room for Chris. That doesn't make sense.
Disappointment.
So patience. You'll probably hear from him again. And if you didn't hear the episode, I really want to recommend to anybody out there who's griping about this, like, oh, I hate Christopher Cantwell. Well, please, have a listen to last night's show. I think it really shows that Chris Cantwell is a person who can grow as a human being. It shows that he is intellectually honest as well. You know, he had a position about the police, and then his experiences that he's had here in Keene, New Hampshire, very much like my experience, his experiences he's had with the police so far have changed have shifted his paradigm of the police and how he approaches them and how he interacts with them. I mean, who would have thought? Think about the Chris Cantwell that you knew maybe 2 or 3 years ago. Who would have thought that Chris Cantwell would have sat down with the police chief for breakfast and had an hour-long conversation?
Doesn't seem like it.
Who would have thought that Chris Cantwell would be exchanging friendly, cordial emails with different members of the Keene Police Department, having conversations with them like human beings? Please, who really would have assigned that behavior to the Chris Cantwell of 2 or 3 years ago?
Well, Cantwell's changed a lot. It's not his associations that have changed. Well, it has been, but as a whole person, he's changed.
I think so, and I think he's changed for the better. And I think that there are people who see the character of Chris Cantwell that they know from past things that he's done and said, and they presume that, well, that's how he'll always be. Well, no, he's a human being just like the rest of us, and just like the rest of us, we're all on a path of hopefully improvement and evolution of ourselves becoming better people. And I've seen that in Chris, and I've seen it in ways that are inspirational, really.
Yeah,
I
wouldn't disagree, and I think that Cantwell in real life is much better than sort of Cantwell on the internet.
Even Cantwell on the internet has it. You know, he's written about his experiences with the Keene police and has said positive things, and much to the chagrin of some of his more angry listeners, right? Like, you traitor! You know, he's getting all kinds of grief from these people. Of course, he's used to getting grief from people, so he's totally comfortable being himself, I think.
And I guess the one thing I would say regarding this is that it seems to me that Cantwell, his intention appears to be that he wants to kind of shore up the libertarian base. He wants to make sure that people in the liberty movement think the right things. And Free Talk Live's mission is not that. Free Talk Live's mission is to go out and find new people to bring to the liberty movement and to make essentially a bigger, a bigger umbrella to bring people into the umbrella, understanding that there's many different ways to believe when you believe in the ideas of liberty. Cantwell's message seems to be very much there's one way to believe when you believe in the ideas of liberty, and that is, you know, this way, this way, this way, and this way.
And that's fine. You know, he can have his message, and when he's here on Free Talk Live, he can represent his viewpoint, and he can be called out on the carpet because of that, in the same way that you could call him out at Keenevention when he's speaking. Which he'll be doing this year at keenvention.info. We can tell you more about that a little bit later. But I'm glad that you guys have seen the shift in Chris as well. And I think it's been it's kind of what I'd hoped would happen for him, because I think that it's inevitable. I think that when you come to a place like Keene, New Hampshire, where there are only 40 police, 40 uniformed cops, there's a few other office staff, but there's only 40 cops, and you go out and you do activism, you're going to encounter those police at some point, and you're going to likely have some kind of conversation with them, and it's going to be surprisingly good compared to what you might have expected. In his case, one of the big shifting events for him was when he drew his gun on some drunk, dangerous people that were intending to attack him and probably hurt him on Main Street in Keene. And when the police arrived, he didn't get shot by them. And in fact, they actually treated him with respect and courtesy. And for him, that was actually an interesting situation for Chris for two reasons. One, it helped shift his paradigm on the police, like that these guys aren't necessarily evil people. Two, it changed his paradigm on drawing a gun on somebody. Because in the gun circles, and, you know, I've used firearms a number of times, but in the gun circles, there's a saying that goes, if you don't pull a gun on somebody unless you intend to pull the trigger.
See, I intend to pull the trigger, I believe.
Unless you're going to, or whatever. I'm not sure what the exact saying is.
Right.
But like,
I think that there's two sayings here. Two completely different sayings. Don't pull a gun unless you're going to use it. Yeah. Don't pull a gun unless you are prepared to use it.
There are different variants on that, I think, that are out there. But there's a common view that if you're going to pull a gun, you're supposed to shoot the person you're pulling the gun on. Okay, that's the common concept. And that incident with Chris having three or four people coming at him and having to pull his gun and ultimately not firing it. You know, he did have his finger on the trigger. It was a revolver, so he would have had to pull it back a little bit to make it fire. Because if you know a semi-auto, if you even touch a trigger of those guns, it's going to fire. Mm-hmm. So had it been a semi-auto and he'd touched it like that, it would have fired. But he had just sort of pulled it back slightly, preparing to fire if necessary. But he didn't. And it really made him question, you know, everything that he believed about pulling a gun on somebody, because that's never happened to him before. And so it's the difference between the theory and the reality of him being able to empathize. I know Chris Cantwell can empathize. Him being able to empathize with the drunk guy, the guys who are coming at him, and being able to put himself in their shoes.
I can empathize with them staring down the barrel of that little .38. I bet they just they just stopped right where they were.
They didn't. Actually, they kept coming. You didn't see the video?
Well,
There's more coming up here in moments. Our username on Skype, if you want to comment, username is lrn.fm. So again, I highly recommend last night's episode. We'll continue this one in moments.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to purse.freetalklive.com and open an account. Do this right now, don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to purse.freetalklive.com right now and get signed up and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 25% off of everything on Amazon through purse.freetalklive.com. It's purse.freetalklive.com.
Hi, this is Ted Anderson. Have you ever wondered why banks, stockbrokers, investment advisors won't talk about gold IRAs? They've been available since 1986, yet the financial industry won't recognize the value of gold for your retirement. Gold has outperformed paper investments, yet no word about IRAs. If you would like to have gold for your retirement, call 800-686-2237. Don't get left behind by rising inflation and low returns. Call 800-686-2237. Secure your future and call 1-800-686-2237.
We are a survival company. We manufacture our own line of Level 3 and Level 3A body armor. We proudly make our armor 100% in America. We have the best prices in the nation, about $125 cheaper than our nearest competitor. All lab certified, for thou art my rock and my fortress, Psalm 31:3. We are Fortress Survival LLC. .com.
Hi, I'm Daryl W. Perry, and I need your help to give away my newest book. Yes, you heard that right. I want to give away my newest book, A Rebel's Journey. The book describes my path to the ideas of liberty, which began as a search for traditional values. I will only give away the book if I reach my fundraising goal of $2,500.
But wait, there's more!
If you donate, not only can you get the ebook and the audiobook for free, but you can get bonus audio content, including interviews with Jeffrey Tucker, Lynn Ulbricht, Ben Stone, Gardner Goldsmith, and Stephen Kinsella. Or you can get a signed copy of the paperback book and more. Your donation will serve to replace the profits I would have earned through a more traditional publication of the book. The funds raised will allow me to get the book into the hands of more people and to promote the book to a wider audience. To find out more about the book or to donate, visit arebelsjourney.com.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
Why are you playing a slot machine sound for an online poker site?
Do you have a poker sound effect? Because we have a new advertiser, swcpoker.eu.
Brought to you by the same guys that did Seals with Clubs.
Now they're called swcpoker.eu. It's Bitcoin Poker 2.0. They have lots of new games, including Chinese poker. The Krill leaderboard is active now. It's Bitcoin Poker from the brand you trust, swcpoker.eu.
Get on over to swcpoker.eu and start playing now.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
Back now with more Free Talk Live. We're talking about how people evolve over time. At least hopefully. That's the intention. That's certainly something that I believe happens with folks. As we learn, we experience things in life, we evolve as into better, what I think hopefully will be better people. And that's kind of what we were talking about with Chris Cantwell, or that's what I was talking with Chris about last night on the show, and just basically recapping for those of you who weren't tuned in to our Sunday edition of Free Talk Live. Joining you in the studio tonight, you've got me, Ian.
Renee.
And King Mark the First.
Well, so you can join us on Skype tonight. We're cutting off phone lines tonight. There's no phone line access. You can call Skype. Skype username's LRN.fm. And so that's why I think that, you know, people, I understand why libertarians like to ostracize. That's what they believe in. They believe in ostracism, right? Like, if you don't like somebody or they're bad or whatever, then you should ostracize them. And I don't disagree that ostracism should be a tool in your belt, but I don't think that it should be the first tool, unless somebody's done something absolutely horrifying that for some reason is unforgivable. I think people deserve some forgiveness and some second chances if they, you know, are generally good folks and you care about them.
And they're contrite for what they did?
Yeah, sure. So I think that's important. Although, all that said, Mark, I think that it's important to forgive people even if they're not contrite, because to hold a grudge is bad for you on your inside. Hate only hurts the hater.
Can you expect somebody to do something different? I'm not saying not forgive, but I mean, like, there's a difference. Okay, so forgiveness has—
You don't have to forget about it.
Yeah. Forgiveness has many shades, and I would say that forgiveness is mainly for the forgiver.
I totally agree.
Yeah.
Which is why I say you don't— the other person doesn't have to necessarily be contrite in order to receive
it. I would concur with you on that. But if you, for instance, you know, forgive somebody for doing something that they're not sorry for doing, and then you continue to sort of do business with them
That'd
and be around
problem.
Them, then you can expect the same stuff that got you into the situation at the first time.
You don't want to keep letting the heroin addict into your jewelry compartment at, you know, in the bathroom where you keep your jewelry or something like that, right? Like, you know, you can still love the heroin addict, but you don't have to allow them access to your valuables. So there's a difference between forgiveness and forgetting who that person currently is at the moment. But who the person is at the moment isn't necessarily the same person that that person was a year ago or a few years ago or whatever. And in the case of Chris Cantwell, I believe that that's the case. So if you want to hear more about his experience, then I would recommend listening to last night's show. And of course, you can go to his blog, ChristopherCantwell.com. We continue here. We were talking earlier about the state cracking down in Indiana on these poor elderly folks just trying to enjoy a game of Euchre. And I got to say, I'm not surprised. Who in their right mind would call in to defend the police on this? Now, I guess technically it's not the police, it's the Indiana Gaming Commission, but I bet you they have their own enforcement arm, the Gaming Commission, sort of like the—
I'll bet they do, you
know,
too.
The tax man here in New Hampshire. I know there's not that many taxes here, but there was the incident with the sales tax people that were coming to the food tax, I guess, because there's no technical sales tax. There's a food— prepared food stacks that came and targeted the Porcupine Freedom Festival this year. There was an enforcer who was with one of the bureaucrats there. And so they do absolutely have police who can enforce this. In this case, what they did was the Gaming Commission came after the senior center. And the senior center, of course, they don't want to risk anybody getting arrested. And they are likely a government-operated organization in the first place. So they went ahead and decided to shut down any kind of card playing for prizes. Because apparently, if you play cards, in this case Euchre, if you play that game and you give somebody a $2 pack of canned peaches, I think was one of the prizes, that's illegal in Indiana. And that could get you arrested for doing that.
Cans of peaches cost $2?
I have no idea.
I would doubt that.
So if you want to share your thoughts here, we're at Skype username lrn.fm. I highly doubt we'll be digging up anyone who will actually take the side of the Indiana Gaming Commission, but I would love to hear from someone like that. Mark, you wanted to share with us a story about a general. This is a little bit of good news. One of the retired generals who has come out and said that drone strikes actually create terrorists.
Yeah, this is coming from firstlook.org.
That's Glenn Greenwald's site, right?
Yeah. That indeed it is. Retired Army General Mike Flynn, a top intelligence official in the post 9/11 years in Iraq and Afghanistan, says in a forthcoming interview on Al Jazeera English that the drone war is creating more terrorists than it's killing. He also asserts that the U.S. invasion of Iraq helped create the Islamic State and that U.S. soldiers involved in torturing detainees need to be held legally accountable for their actions. Sounds like this guy hates America.
He's a general.
Yeah, this general with the Defense Intelligence Agency, who, so maybe he knows a little more than, say, I don't know, Sean Hannity, right?
Yeah.
who might claim that if you say that the drones are creating more terrorists than they're killing,
you hate
say
America.
You're part of the hate America first crowd. Now, I don't really, I like America in the sense of,
I believe that this is a very special piece of land. The United States is positioned in a way, in such a way between countries that makes it extraordinarily safe, that in that way we are abundantly blessed. But the United States, I reserve that term to mean the government. I believe the United States is an organ. The United States of America is the name of an organization of politicians and bureaucrats that claim to have dominion over us all. Now, politician, I believe that term is synonymous with liar and thief. If you disagree with this, that you don't think that, I don't know, 75% of politicians are a bunch of, you know, sociopathic liars and thieves, please call in.
Would love to hear from you.
Username lrn.fm on Skype. But that's how I see it. So, no, am I a hate the United States first crowd? No, I'm not really for any organization that claims a monopoly privilege over a given landmass. That's what a state is. A state is an organization that claims dominion, claims a monopoly on violence in a given landmass. So there you go. Do I hate America first? No. I just dislike this organizational model.
So he's saying drones cause more terrorists. I mean, can you imagine what it would be like to be, you know, going to work and these death machines are flying in the skies and actually bombing people? I mean,
it's really going to kill productivity, isn't it?
Horrifying.
Besides your children, productivity is going to be shot too.
Yeah, I mean, you wouldn't really want to go to work, but you still have to go to work, right? So, you know, you have to keep doing something.
And
so
let's be sure to talk about how these people are stuck in the Stone Age too. You know, we'll just demean them because we're
talking about Afghanistan.
Yeah, all that stuff over there. People say that the Middle East is, you know, this is the problems and whatever. You know, there's places in the Middle East that looked pretty nice. Baghdad looked pretty good. Kabul looked pretty good at one point in its history. Yeah, that wasn't recent history, but you can't claim the United States hasn't had any kind of role there. So also, he's claiming that the invasion of Iraq helped create the Islamic State, which I think is an undeniable statement. Would the Islamic State exist today if the invasion of Iraq had not occurred? And you're going to have to, you know, you're going to have to put a pretty complex possible future together, possible alternate history together to claim otherwise.
Well, you know, before the Islamic State, of course, Al-Qaeda was the big boogeyman, right? That was the one that was right before the Islamic State. And I guess some would say that Al-Qaeda hasn't gone away. It's just, you know,
not as important as the Islamic State today.
And right. And you never saw Al-Qaeda, as bad as they supposedly were, you never saw Al-Qaeda releasing videos of children slitting people's throats. That one happened recently. I don't know if y'all saw that. Did you guys see that one?
How young was this?
Maybe 10.
Oh, my God.
Maybe 10. So that was after they released a video of like 30 or 40 prisoners. I think they might have been Syrian. I don't have the story in front of me. But prisoners of war, essentially, against the Islamic State. They had these prisoners, and they had a youth, probably aged 8 to 12 or something like that. About 30 or 40 youth standing behind, one behind each of the prisoners. And then it was it was actually held in sort of an amphitheater. So there was actually a crowd of people there to watch this execution.
It's like the Cub Scouts. What? Their version of the Cub Scouts.
There was a crowd of people watching this execution, and they all, you know, simultaneously, when given the order to fire, shot the person who was the prisoner, and they mass murdered dozens of human beings, children. Wow. Did that. And so that video came out before the more recent one, the most recent one, where the approximately 10-year-old is instructed to slice the head off of a man. And that actually happened. I didn't see the video. I saw some still frames from it. The video on heavy.com had been pulled down, apparently, that they had linked to, and I haven't looked further for it. Right.
Nobody wants
to
see this stuff.
Most people do not want
to be seen.
That.
Yeah.
But it's horrifying. And Al-Qaeda wasn't doing that. Right?
No, they weren't.
Yeah. So look what you got now because of the aggression of the United States military. We'll continue here in moments.
It's not just the military, it's the politicians who ordered them there, right?
I see someone on the phone line, so I'm going to instruct our board operator to give that person instructions as to how to call on Skype because we're doing experimental radio tonight. It's Skype only. You can Skype into the show at username lrn.fm. And by the way, Skype's wide open, so feel free to join us here. Hour 2's coming up.
If worse comes to worst, Will you be prepared? You don't have to be a survivalist to prepare for the unexpected. Storing necessary supplies like food, water, and emergency equipment is simply taking responsibility for ourselves and our families when it counts the most. StrategicShelters.com offers emergency supplies and a secure way to store them, and provides protection for loved ones in the event of an extreme natural or man-made disaster. To find out more, visit StrategicShelters.com.
Kid, let me paint you a picture. Tuesday night, your cog belt goes bust. Who will help you get what you need fast? Without the hoops, hurdles, or headaches? Grainger, that's who. I love Grainger. They got a wide variety of products and solutions. Grainger makes it easy to get everything we need and answers for when we're not sure what the answer is. Now, kid, let me paint you another picture. It looks like a mop, a basement bathroom, and you all over it. Get it? Got it? Good. Call clickgrainger.com or stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
Are you tired of your taxes funding endless occupations around the world? Antiwar.com is run by people who understand that wars abroad become wars at home, wars on our freedoms. Antiwar.com is dedicated to bringing you the latest in news, views, interviews, and reviews from the top movers and shakers in the anti-occupation movement. Antiwar.com has it all, from thorough foreign policy analysis to interviews with whistleblowers who used to run the military-industrial complex. Anti-war, pro-free market. That's Antiwar.com.
LRN.fm is proud to announce our official listening apps for Android and iOS devices. Now you can easily tune into our streams anywhere, anytime on your smartphone or tablet. Just visit apps.lrn.fm or search for LRN.fm in the Android or Apple app stores. Please download, rate it 5 stars, then share the link on social media, and let your friends and family know how you're listening to LRN.fm. Download it now, free at apps.lrn.fm. That's apps.lrn.fm.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number 2 is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.fm.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Monday, July 20th, 2015. Silver is trading at $14.80 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,114 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $278. Antiwar.com reports as fighting continues between Yemen's Shiite Houthis and the pro-Saudi faction loyal to former President Hadi, civilians in the port city of Aden remain caught in the middle, paying a deadly price in the drawn-out war. Yesterday, health officials in Aden reported 57 civilians killed and 215 others wounded in heavy Houthi shelling of the Dar Saad neighborhood, a strategically important residential neighborhood in northern Yemen. The Houthis are aiming to reclaim the city after losing much of it last week. Hadi forces are said to be using Dar Saad as a staging ground for their offensive against surrounding Houthi areas, and the shelling was aimed at halting their advance, though the shelling was also said to be relatively random and took a big civilian toll. This has been the case in fighting and strikes all across Yemen since the Saudi war began in March, and the civilian death toll, which crossed 1,500 last week, is rapidly approaching the 2,000 mark over the three-month period. For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. UPI reports German Chancellor Angela Merkel, who has been at the front and center for weeks in the bailout negotiations for Greece, said Sunday that her government is willing to consider further measures to relieve Athens' debt health. Speaking to German television, Merkel said that there are several options on the table to assist Prime Minister Alexis Tsipras' government as it struggles to repay loans and eliminate debt. However, she stipulated that would only be possible once the details of the Greek economic reforms are worked out. Merkel told Germany's ARD TV, "Greece has already been given relief. We had a voluntary haircut among the private creditors, and we then extended maturities once and reduced interest rates," adding, "We can talk now about such possibilities again. Once the first successful review of the program to be negotiated has been completed, then exactly this question will be discussed. Not now, but then." Merkel, though, rejected any idea that officials will consider simply writing off any of Greece's debt. The German government has been closely monitoring the situation because it, as well as other members of the European Union, would be affected should Greece be expelled from the Eurozone. Merkel's remarks Sunday highlight the country's willingness to keep Athens from sliding into a fiscal abyss, while emphasizing Tsipras's government would not simply be given a clean slate without earning it.
You can support FPP Radio by joining the Fans Program. Fans are friends, allies, and Numeri supporters. You can join the Fans Program for as little as $3 per month or any amount of Bitcoin per month, thanks to the recurring payment options provided by Coinbase. To learn more or to join the Fans Program, visit fans.fppradio.com.
Reuters reports firefighters in Southern California, aided by an unusually long burst of rainfall, have dug containment lines around 60% of a brush fire that torched 20 vehicles and destroyed 11 homes and outbuildings. The U.S. Forest Service said on Sunday the wildfire, which broke out on Friday afternoon in the drought-parched foothills of San Bernardino County, grew from 500 acres to 3,500 acres in a matter of hours. U.S. Forest spokeswoman Lynn Silliette said it held that footprint through Sunday, dampened by a day of light rainfall on Saturday. Fire crews were hoping for more rainfall as they worked to expand the containment lines around the rest of the fire perimeter. Officials lifted all evacuation orders and road closures on Saturday evening, and people were returning to the communities of Baldy Mesa and Oak Hills, California. On Friday, the blaze ripped down a portion of Interstate 15 that links Southern California and Las Vegas, forcing 60 drivers to abandon their cars and scramble to safety. 18 cars and two tractor trailers were destroyed, along with 11 homes and outbuildings. A separate 200-acre wildfire northwest of San Bernardino, which triggered evacuations of several campgrounds on Saturday, was 40% contained, and evacuation orders had been lifted on Sunday. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
A prison reform group issued a disturbing new study this week calling conditions in women's correctional facilities deplorably unsexy. The report contends that women's prisons are bleak, dangerous environments with shockingly few soapy showers and erotically charged pillow fights. According to the Prison Justice Initiative, quote, "It's a shame that in today's society we still have jails that don't encourage kittenish girl-on-girl exploration. Prison shouldn't be a hotbed of gang violence and drugs. It should be a steamy Shangri-La where caged nymphets discover the sexuality away from the leering eyes of male society." The investigation revealed living conditions that many are calling cruel and degrading, but not in a fun or kinky way. The study's author argues that incarceration should be about more than just punishment.
The purpose of prison isn't just to lock people in a box and forget about them. It's to provide opportunities for naughty girls to play nice with each other.
Next up, a team of jock scientists have reportedly thrown the cure for asthma onto the roof of the lab. We'll talk to the nerds struggling to retrieve it.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live, and of course, you can join us here, but not toll-free, because tonight we're doing an experimental version of the show, Skype only. So you do need to call us on Skype if you want to get on the air tonight. Skype username is lrn.fm, so please do that. If you don't yet have Skype, it is a free download. I'm not advocating for Skype as far as like it's the best. No, it's just what people use.
It's
right?
The standard.
So it's sort of the Facebook of internet voice over IP communicating, right? Like this is the way people talk online. And yes, you'll probably be recorded by the NSA, but you're calling talk radio, so everybody's listening to your conversation.
Don't worry, anyway, when you're calling the toll-free number, you're being recorded by the NSA too.
Right. So there's really
not
no
a
reason.
Step up.
There's really no reason not to have this. It sounds great. And ultimately, that's sort of the reason for this experiment. Number one, I want to just see how it goes. But number two, maybe it'll encourage more people to download Skype and get it installed. And then when they actually do call, even if it's not tonight, because, you know, not everybody wants to talk about the topics we're discussing.
They don't have to talk about the topics
we're
discussing.
True. You can call in about anything you want. But maybe they're not feeling inspired. You got to feel inspired to pick up Skype or the phone and call talk radio. So join us on Skype at Skype username lrn.fm with
you. So can I, before we go on,
let me introduce the studio here tonight. It's Ian,
Renee.
And King Mark the First.
All right, go ahead, Mark.
So allow me. I spend a lot of time on Free Talk Live's Facebook page. Yes. Helped curate it and
grow it. The help of some excellent meme makers and co-posters, co-admins, if you will. Yep.
Thanks so much to the folks that do, Edison chief among them. But what I notice is that a lot of people will post comments on the Facebook page about, you know, this article or that article or our opinion this way or that way. And I'll, you know, let them know. Some people don't even know they're dealing with a radio program, right? So I try to let them know that, hey, you know, you can call in. If this is important to you, you can call in and talk about that on the air. And the likelihood of them doing that is just so slim. They just don't do it.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm kind of, I guess I'm biased, right? Like, this is just me complaining, right? If it's important enough for you to have written it down on Facebook so that dozens of people might see it, then it should be important enough for you to pick up a telephone and call so that thousands, tens of thousands of people can hear it, right? Like, your opinion, if it is of any value, is of the value that you pick up the phone and call. So if you disagree with something we say, by all means do that. But if you agree, that's fine too. If you've got something out of left field, it's Free Talk Live.
Yeah, that's true. They like
Skype,
that.
The Skype username is lrn.fm. Stop feeling in your life like you are unheard. Be heard.
All right. So, Mark, tell us more in recap for those just tuning in about this general, retired general.
Yeah, retired Army General Mike Flynn.
And what he's saying about terrorism.
Yeah, he said, firstlook.org, this article, he's saying, top intelligence official in the post-9/11 wars in Iraq and Afghanistan says in a forthcoming interview on Al Jazeera English that the drone war is creating more terrorists than it's killing. He also asserts that the U.S. invasion of Iraq helped create the Islamic State, seems obvious, and that the U.S. soldiers involved in torturing detainees need to be held legally accountable for their actions.
Oh, well, that's probably not going to happen. But
I don't think it didn't look like it.
Yeah.
Flynn, who is in 2014, was forced out of the head of the Defense Intelligence Agency. 2014? There wasn't a lot of war going on there. Was there? I mean, it's only last
2014?
Year. 2014?
Yeah. I mean, Afghanistan and Iraq, there were
Iraq was done,
there, right?
I mean,
I know people keep saying it's done, but there's still troops over there, aren't there?
There's troops everywhere in 130 countries. That doesn't mean there's a particular
hot war. Do you think the people
in
Iraq feel as though they're at war if they're occupied by U.S. troops? Would you feel like you might be in a wartime state if the Chinese troops were on your neighborhood streets?
Do you think that Okinawa's at war?
Are they confined to their bases or in Okinawa, or are they actually out and about?
Yeah, they go out and go out in the town and do stuff.
Hmm. Okay, so nobody's been attacked in Iraq over the last couple years?
By U.S. troops?
No,
I think they're in a training position, mostly, and to protect the embassies and that sort of thing.
So the troops haven't been attacked at all? There's been no skirmishes?
I don't think so.
Hmm. Okay.
I don't think so. Maybe I'm wrong on that, but I don't think so. Let's see. He was forced out in 2014 of the DIA.
ISIS was occupying cities in Iraq.
Yeah, but I don't think the U.S. is going after them. I think they're flying only air support. Hmm.
Okay. Like I said, I don't keep close track, but if you want to know more about
this
stuff.
If the United States wanted to take back a city in Iraq, that would have been done yesterday.
You could go to antiwar.com, and they'll definitely give you what's going on.
He was, in recent months, became an outspoken critic of Obama administration's Middle East strategy, calling for a more hawkish approach to the Islamic State and Iran. So I guess he's claiming for more attacks there.
This general?
Let's see. Flynn, who was forced out as the head of the DIA, has in recent months become an outspoken critic of the Obama administration's Middle East strategy, calling for a more hawkish approach to the Islamic State in Iran. But his enthusiasm for the application of force doesn't extend to the use of drones. In the interview with the Al Jazeera presenter...
So he's no peacemonger, that's for sure.
Mahdi Hassan, sent to air in July the 31st, the former three-star general says, when you drop a bomb from a drone, you're going to cause more damage than you are good. You're going to cause good. Pressed by Hassan as to whether drone strikes are creating more terrorists than they kill, Flynn says, I don't disagree with that. He describes the present approach of drone warfare as a failed strategy. What we have is this continued investment in conflict.
Well, that's what I was going to say. It depends on how you look at it, right? Like, if it's a failure from his perspective, he's right about that. I mean, you look at different factors of, is it creating more terrorists? Yes. So it's a failure from that perspective. If the goal was to stop terrorism, But the goal's not really to stop terrorism now, is it? The goal is to funnel money into the military-industrial complex. And every time a bomb goes off, that's a cash register ringing for those industrial complex folks.
Because you're going to have to build another right. one of those things that you just dropped.
So from their perspective, it's a total success.
Yeah, I also, you know, so I can understand why somebody feels like, look, you got to go in and clean up ISIS and then you can get out of the Middle East. I get where somebody comes from when they say that. My heart says the same thing. Look, we got to just go in there and take care of that problem and then there won't be, then you can leave. But that's kind of the thought process that got you where you were in the first place.
Yeah.
You know, the idea
was, wipe out Al Qaeda.
The idea was to go into Iraq and take care of Hussein and get out. Well, how'd that go? You were there and years and years after Hussein was caught hiding in a hole in the ground.
Right. At the very least, that was their excuse to get in. I don't trust anything they say.
Absolutely. We know that they lied about the yellow cake and the weapons of mass destruction and lies.
Some lied.
Lies,
some believed the lies. I mean, I believe that Colin Powell believed that lie.
Mm-hmm.
Right,
so he was passing on misinformation.
So, and what's important to understand here is that information was gleaned in part from torture. And so just it's the snowball of hawkishness that brought the United States to where it is today. Yes, things were terrible post 9/11. I mean, it was an awful feeling being attacked like that. But I suspect if you talk to the people who did it, that they would say, look, this is how we feel already. Welcome to the club. And that's why they attacked. They didn't attack Switzerland. They attacked the United States for a reason. They attacked the World Trade Center and the Pentagon for reasons. These were, important targets to them.
Did they, though?
What's that?
Did they attack the World Trade Center?
Are you a conspiracy theorist? Are you like a 9/11 truther or something?
I don't want to call myself a conspiracy theorist, but at the same time, I don't trust anything they say because they lie about everything.
That's
so
true.
I'll never know what happened on 9/11.
That's my answer, is I really don't know.
I don't know either. But
I don't care.
I would not be surprised if a small cadre of young Arab men decided, you know what, I'm sick and tired of the U.S.'s foreign policy in the Middle East, so I'm going to do something about it. At the same time, Building 7 sort of interesting, but I don't think it's going to make a difference, so I don't research this crap.
That's the third building that fell, even though it wasn't hit by a plane?
When I say I don't research it anymore. Like, I just don't think it's going to change anything.
I saw the movie, the various different conspiracy theory movies about this
and
years
the debunking
ago.
Of those. Yeah. So, whatever.
All right, tell me more.
Prior to serving as the director of the Defense Intelligence Agency, Flynn was director of the intelligence for the Joint Special Operations Command during the wars in Iraq and Afghanistan. During his time in Iraq, Flynn is credited with helping to transform JSOC into
an intelligence. So he's got credit. He's a general, right? So these are the things he's saying. You can share your thoughts with us, but you do have to Skype into the show. Skype username is lrn.fm, and you can join us here. There's more Free Talk Live on the way. You do need to send a contact request first. If you haven't done so, just send that over to username lrn.fm. We'll approve it, and then you can call right away. This is Free Talk Live. More on the way.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to purse.freetalklive.com and open an account. Do this right now, don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to purse.freetalklive.com right now and get signed up and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 25% off of everything on Amazon through purse.freetalklive.com. It's purse.freetalklive.com.
Is negative content or comments on the web affecting your personal or professional reputation? Unfavorable comments, embarrassing pictures, videos, legal documents, and bad tweets can ruin your personal life, your career, or your business. It happens a lot, and it's just not fair.
But what can you do? Reputation.com can protect your good name. Get a free consultation now at 800-831-0771. That's 800-831-0771. Call right now for a free expert reputation analysis. It's easy to squash the unfair attacks with our patented system, and the analysis is absolutely free. Make the best things about you jump out in searches. Protect your personal and professional reputation, your business, and your income. Get your free reputation analysis from Reputation.com right now. Call 800-831-0771. 800-831-0771. 800-831-0771.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to purse.freetalklive.com and open an account. Do this right now, don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to purse.freetalklive.com right now and get signed up and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 25% off of everything on Amazon through purse.freetalklive.com. It's purse.freetalklive.com.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. Skype only calls tonight. Skype username is lrn.fm. So feel free to join us right there. You do need to send a contact request first. We'll approve it, and you'll be good to go from that point forward. Once again, Skype username's lrn.fm. We've been talking about generals. One general in particular that is saying the terrorists are being created by the drone strikes. The more bombs you drop on people, surprise, they get angry about that. Wait, you just killed some innocent children, some wives and children? Well, someone might just go ahead and decide to dedicate their lives to suicide bombing once their entire family has had their lives extinguished by a drone strike.
I think that the best way to approach this is to walk a mile in your brother's moccasins. And by brother, I mean, if you hate people in the Middle East, that's your brother. That's who I'm talking about.
Mm-hmm.
Imagine what it would be like if a foreign power dropped a bomb that killed your mom or your dad or, you know, whomever, how you would feel. Now, as a child, as a young person, you likely aren't looking at sort of the fairness of the situation. Well, you know, dad was engaged in a guerrilla conflict against this, this superpower. And, these are the reasons that the United States is so great or whatever. They're not looking at those things. They're looking at what happened to them and in their lives. Because all around the world, people want to be like the United States. U.S.'s foreign policy is ruining that. It's taking young people and, turning them against the United States,
oh, yeah,
which is terrible, terrible for the United States.
So that's not the only general that's been in the news. This one coming from InfoWars, and I had to watch the video just to make sure that InfoWars wasn't blowing this headline out of proportion, because they have a tendency that they might do something like that from time to time. over on InfoWars. And the headline is Wesley Clark, who is also a former general, calls for interning disloyal Americans. And I have the video here from MSNBC.
People would say you reap what you sow. So how do we fix self-radicalized lone wolves domestically?
Well, we've got to identify the people who are most likely to be radicalized. We've got to cut this off at the beginning. There are always a certain number of young people who are alienated. They don't get a job, they lost a girlfriend, their family doesn't feel happy here. Mm-hmm. And we can watch the signs of that, and there are members of the community who will reach out to those people and bring them back in and encourage them to look at their blessings here. But I do think on a national policy level, we need to look at what...
Reach out to those people, bring them back in, encourage them to look at their blessings here. They actually tried doing this to me when I was coming back from Canada. I went to a little Run for the Border event that we put together during the Porcupine Freedom Festival. Me and several other activists went up and attempted to cross the Canadian border. I ultimately failed. The others succeeded. There's going to be a video about this. But I haven't yet taken the time to edit that together.
What was the point of that, by the way?
Just to experiment and to see what it would take to get through the border. So we tried, different people had different forms of identification, for instance. One lady had she had just her driver's license from Georgia, and I had a world passport, and one guy had his Canadian passport, so he got in pretty easy. And then I think Garrett Ian was using a driver's license as well, although he did have his passport on him. He only showed it if he was asked to show it. So we all kind of took a different approach, a different tack to making that crossing. Oh, and another guy had the enhanced driver's license, which is sort of like not quite a passport, but it'll get you across without much trouble.
So who got across?
Everyone except me.
In fact, you're banned now, aren't you?
If I try to go back to Canada, I will be arrested. unless I go through some sort of program.
Me too, buddy.
Pay money in order to get them to sort of reallow you in.
I know we're heard in Canada, at least to some small extent. And I'd like to say, Canadians, your government's policy on this is stupid. Because what were you going to do when you went to Canada?
Going to go have some lunch.
You were going to spend money you went to Canada.
I actually ended up having the lunch anyway because someone bought it for me and brought it back over.
Oh, that's awesome.
Yeah.
But if you could go to Canada, you would go to Canada more often and do what?
Probably spend some
money. Spend money.
Yeah, I've actually at one time wanted to go to see a concert in Canada.
If you went to Canada at any point, I cannot imagine you doing anything that would harm anyone else because you don't do that here in the United States.
But that's just it, Mark. They don't want me there because I had a misdemeanor conviction of obstructing government administration, which means I am trouble for the state in their mind.
Yeah, well, that's stupid. Again, Canadians, your government's policy on this is stupid. I have been to more than a dozen countries as a convicted felon, spent untold thousands of dollars in these countries. And I get my money's not that valuable. Canada's a, you know, rich and wealthy nation. But you're not gaining anything by keeping Ian and I and every other felon and a lot of misdemeanor-type people out.
Well, they let some misdemeanors come in. So had I had a misdemeanor for marijuana possession or something like that, I'd probably have been okay. But my misdemeanor was centered around the idea of being a sort of a not pro-government person, right? And so that could mean I could be trouble, right? That might mean I might say no if a cop tells me to do something. I might, you know, keep recording if I'm told to stop recording. I'm kind of a disobedient, non-cooperative person. So from the perspective of the state, I can understand why they wouldn't want to let somebody with that conviction on their record through. I can understand it. I mean, I don't agree with it. I think it is stupid. Because obviously I'm not interested in going and setting Canada free. I'm not going to be going up there to, you know, purposefully disobey. But from their perspective, I could be trouble
Canada
for them.
Canada sucks anyway. Who cares?
I don't know. I mean,
I think Canada's great. I would love to go to Montreal. I've never been there, and it'd be awesome. But I'm not going to pay you $1,000.
That's what they want because you have a felony. It's $1,000.
Yeah, $1,000 so that I can just travel into Canada and spend more money.
Right.
No thanks. Just not that interesting. Our great frozen neighbor to the north is simply not $1,000 interesting to me.
They want $250 or $200, I think, per misdemeanor. I think it's per. I'm not exactly clear on that. I think you have to wait like 5 or 10 years. Anyway, I don't even remember why we were talking about the trip to Canada.
Are you permanently banned from Canada?
No,
or just
no, unless I go through this process that Mark is talking about, where you pay. In my case, it would be a few $100. In his case, it'd be $1,000, and then you have to go through this sort of re-education or something like. There's some term
I don't remember what it is off the top of my head, but...
re-unalienated or something like
yeah,
that?
Yeah, I don't remember what it is. It's something like that. Like, you know, you be re-allowed to get into society, basically. Yeah.
You're incorrigible anyway, as far as, they, as, far as they're concerned.
Yeah, and they also didn't like my conviction for unsworn falsification from 2014 as well. So that's what prevented me from going in there. But back to this guy who is saying that he wants to put people in camps. Oh, yeah, he was talking about re-education. For people. So if you are one of these angry teenagers he's talking about or angry young people that you should be talked to. Oh, yes. So this is what I was saying before. They talked to me. When I came back across the border into the U.S. side, I got a lecture from those guys. And
from the U.S.?
Yeah. So one of the guys on the
U.S. Did you just walk away?
No, I was being detained.
Did you ask them if you were being detained?
You had to... When you're in the custody of the Border Patrol, you are being detained when you're crossing from another country. Like, you can't not go to the Border Patrol station until they release you, right? Otherwise, you're going to get arrested. So I was being detained and questioned by these people. And obviously, you don't have to answer their questions, I guess, but they are going to detain you for longer if you don't. And so I was being told, lectured, about how great this country is, because I wouldn't actually admit to being a citizen. This is what he wanted me to do. He, you know, was asking, "Are you a U.S. citizen?" And I told him, I gave him dodgy answers like, "Well, I think that you would probably consider me to be a citizen, right?" I don't believe in the concept, right? I was born ostensibly in the supposed United States and on that plot of land, but that doesn't mean that I believe in citizenship. So that led into this lecture from this guy. Anyway, we'll come back with more with this general who wants to lock you up, maybe.
We the people grow cotton, weave fabric, engrave ink, embed strips and fibers to protect from counterfeit, then carting to a private bank, having it lent back at interest, forcing taxes to service debt. This capitalism, or was Jefferson correct when stating a central bank issuing the public currency is a greater menace to the liberties of the people than a standing army? Ted Anderson, I'm placing a free silver dollar in a book that explains our monetary system. Call for your copy, 800-686-2237. It's time to understand the system. Call 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
Virtually anyone can hack your cell phone and track your calls, your texts, your emails, your every movement, but only if they can detect a signal. Stay one step ahead of hackers and Big Brother with a Blockit Pocket, a custom-made pocket infused with pure silver that creates a complete Faraday enclosure for your cell phone. For free shipping to the Lower 48, visit blockitpocket.com or call 888-315-9618, blockitpocket.com, enhancing health and privacy.
Our digital freedom is under attack. Look no further than Ross Ulbricht's life sentence to see that. After all, it's not Ross's freedom they're after. It's yours.
It is bigger than Ross and bigger than a website. I think one website is by far less dangerous than the government trampling on our rule of law.
The appeal is underway, and we've organized a grassroots fundraiser at thecryptoshow.com/freeRoss. Up for grabs is Cody Wilson's Ghost Gunner, A Week in Costa Rica, My Magic Mud, Ghost Outside the Machine t-shirt.
These prizes are really great. There's a ton more, so go to thecryptoshow.com/freeRoss. Please tell all your friends, share it up.
Our grassroots tactics allow for 100% of all funds raised to go directly to freeRoss.org. So check out thecryptoshow.com/freeRoss. And don't forget, freeross.org.
Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website or idea. Email me, Mark, at freetalklive.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are: one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
Are you a helpless moron perplexed by the world? Wish there was a device that enabled you to consult the Onion Book of Known Knowledge anytime, anywhere? Then you need the Book Bjorn, the amazing new wearable invention that makes you and the Onion Book of Known Knowledge inseparable. Never again be stumped by the panoply of bizarre objects filling your field of vision. Never take it off. Never be without it. All this for just four easy payments of $39.93. The Book Bjorn. The Book Bjorn. And if you call now, you'll receive the special page-turning wand. Turn pages with the greatest of ease. The special reading light to wrench knowledge from utter darkness. The Book Umbrella to protect the Onion Book of Known Knowledge's precious pages from the elements. Book Bjorn! This $800 value can be yours today. Send a check or money order to the Book Bjorn, care of the Zwiebel Center for Knowledge Studies, 15 Zwiebel Way, Macau, China. Do not hesitate. Buy now. The Book Bjorn.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. We have Skype. You can Skype into the show tonight. LRN.FM is the Skype username that you'll need to connect to. Whether you want to talk about the bad general who is about to claim that you ought to be rounded up. If you are someone who dares to question the state, you're trouble. And they want to put you in camps. At least this guy does. And I imagine there are other people who agree with him. What, he being an army general who's retired and everything. Wesley Clark. I've even heard that name before.
Yeah, well, he ran for, I think he was a presidential candidate in 2006.
He's so, he actually is called the Supreme Allied Commander of Europe.
No, 2004, for the 2004 race. Dude, there wasn't a 2006 race. Here's my question, though. Who's he wanting to round up and put in camps?
We'll get to
because that's kind of an important distinction. There's the nation's right now reeling from an attack that killed five servicemen, and people are sort of hot under the collar about that.
He wants to round up people who are disloyal to the United States, people who might be a threat verbally to, or maybe physically to the United States, people who are not fully in line with loving the United States, which I think would qualify many of our listeners and co-hosts here on Free Talk Live. But yeah. let me let him say it for himself here.
Please do.
Let's continue with the audio from MSNBC. So he started out talking about angry young people who are, disaffected. I'll jump it back here so you can hear exactly what he said in case you're just tuning in.
There are always a certain number of young people who are alienated. They don't get a job. They lost a girlfriend. Their family doesn't feel happy here. Mm-hmm. And we can watch the signs of that. And there are members of the community who will reach out to those people and bring them back in and encourage them to look at their blessings here.
That's what happened to me at the border. This is what I was telling you before, where they tried to explain to me, because I was pretty clear that I'm no fan of the idea of U.S. citizenship, right? That's what I said, essentially, to these Border Patrol agents. And one of them went off on a lecture about, actually, two of them went off on a lecture about how great it is in the United States and how much better it is to other places in the rest of the world.
I think comparatively, that's likely a true statement, yeah. That there's many advantages to living in the United States.
But it's also not ranked as the number one most economically free country in the world. In fact, it's not even in the top 10. Not a free country.
Well,
social freedoms, it's down like way.
Is there
way
a social
down.
Freedom chart? I know there's
there
the
is.
Freedom it, of speech chart.
There is. It was about, we're about number 40
wow.
or so.
I don't recall that. Who puts that one out?
Hold on just a second. I'll tell you. I've got it in my long-term prep
here. Yeah, just a curiosity. But yeah, they gave me this lecture, and that sounds like exactly what he's saying here. We need to bring them back. Bring them back into the fold. Have the community members remind them about how great it is here. There shall be no questioning the United States.
But I do think on a national policy level, we need to look at what self-radicalization means, because we are at war with this group of terrorists. They do have an ideology. In World War II, if someone supported Nazi Germany at the expense of the United States, we didn't say that was freedom of speech. We put him in a camp.
There were lots of sort of famous people that were quite fascist and to some extent supported Germany before the war. Walt Disney comes to mind, as does Henry Ford to some extent. I'm no expert in this area. World War II is not my bailiwick, but it seems there certainly were some. We didn't put them in camps.
Well, people were put in camps. There were people that were put in camps.
Sure, they did that for their color, though.
Yeah. Well, Germans and Japanese people, I mean, they're white Germans. They were put in camps too, right?
From capitalismisfreedom.com, very few of them. The Cato Institute conducted a study on personal freedoms of all countries all over the world. They measured the degree to which people were free to enjoy civil liberties, speech, association, assembly, etc., as well as freedom of movement and the amount of legal discrimination based on gender and sexuality.
Who was that put that together?
Cato.
Oh, Cato. All right. So let me continue here with the clip.
They were prisoners of war. So if these people are radicalized and they don't support the United States and they're disloyal to the United States.
Radicalized, don't support the United States, and are disloyal to the United States. I personally want nothing whatsoever to do with the United States. I have no loyalty to the United States. I suspect, you know, I don't know what it means to be radicalized, but I'm certainly in favor.
I suspect you're in that camp,
buddy. Certainly in favor of peace, and if peace is considered radical, then okay. That's fine. So that's who he's talking about here. Let me continue.
As a matter of principle, fine. That's their right. It's our right and our obligation to segregate them from the normal community for the duration of the conflict.
That's your right, he says, to believe the way you want about the United States. It's our right to segregate you from the community for the duration of the conflict. How long will the war on terrorism go on for?
I think he's really just talking about people who are Islamic here, right? Like, he
no,
doesn't
sir,
want to say
it. No, sir, he is
it.
Not talking about people right. who is, are Islamic. He's talking about people who are disloyal
and
to
I'm
the
not,
United States.
I'm not supporting
States.
That.
He's talking about domestic people, too.
Right, but I mean, he's doing it in the... Okay, Ian, I think that he's just not wanting to say the words.
You can be Islamic and loyal to the United States.
Sure you
so
can.
So he's not just talking about people who believe in the Islamic religious code.
I think the application of what he's saying would likely to be what you're talking about. Mm-hmm. Anybody who disagrees with the line. This is a fundamentally anti-American thing that he's saying.
He's saying you can have your free speech and disagree with the United States, but you just need to be segregated into a camp during the during the duration of the conflict, just like World War II. Hey, we let the Japanese Americans and those German Americans out afterwards. And you said there was a small number. You meant of Germans, not of Japanese, right? There was a lot of Japanese.
Just about everybody with a Japanese surname that lived on the West Coast.
So, yeah they let them out after the conflict was over. But remember what I think was Dick Cheney or Donald Rumsfeld, one of those guys, said about the war on terrorism, is that there is no end to this conflict.
No, there isn't.
There's no enemy out there that you can specifically target because they've got a uniform on and you can count when all of the uniformed people have perished. Terrorism is this sort of diffuse, nebulous concept.
There will never be somebody who doesn't disagree with the United States enough to pick up a weapon, especially if the United States is at war in the Middle East over a course of decades. If first it was Al-Qaeda, now it's morphed into the Islamic State. It'll be Al-Qaeda again when it needs to be, and it'll be some new enemy in the future.
So I don't think that it's stretching anything at all to say this man is literally talking about putting people in camps who disagree with the United States as a concept, people who are radicals, as he says, into camps till further notice. It will be until the end of the existence of the United States, because the war on terrorism, they have the intention to continue it forever. Just like they want to continue the war on drugs, they're going to milk that for as long as they possibly can, for as much money and as much power as they possibly can. They certainly have done so, and the war on terror is the exact same thing, except even more lucrative for them.
Well, it's like having a war on sunshine. There will always, as we know it, there will always be sun.
At least in our lifetimes, hopefully. Yes.
Right, we hope. There will always be terror. There will always be drugs.
Especially as long as they're dropping bombs on people. As we talked about earlier, the last general pointed out that the war on terrorism, specifically the drones that are dropping bombs, are creating new terrorists. But that's not a new message. That's what was written, what was the book Blowback that came out years ago during the Bush administration, mm-hmm. pointing out, hey, guess what? You go around the world invading people's countries and occupying their territory and killing people. Oh, wow. Don't be surprised when you've formed new terrorists, when new people have risen up through the ranks and have become terrorists because of what has happened to their friends and their family at the hands of this U.S. government. So this guy literally is talking about internment camps.
I think we're going to have to increasingly get tough on this, not only in the United States, but our allied nations like Britain and Germany and France.
Worldwide camps. Camps all around the world. Every country that is that has dissidents, that has people who are against their government, these people are sick, he's saying, and they need to be re-educated. That's what this guy's saying.
I don't know that re-education's ever going... Like, that sounds like a government program that's just simply not going to work, right? I mean, let's put a bunch of people in a place and, like, teach them... You know, it's ridiculous. It doesn't make any sense at all.
Well, to his credit, he didn't use the word re-education. He just said keep them in camps until the war's over.
Well, the wars are never going to end. Yeah.
He said you could try to intervene before you put them in the camps, but ultimately that's where you belong, you
so
libertarians.
So stupid. Ridiculous.
You people with your ODD. Everyone with ODD, oppositional defiance disorder, you're going to the camps.
We're in for a long stay then, I guess.
This is real. I mean, this is an actual clip from MSNBC. This guy, Wesley Clark, retired U.S. Army general, the former supreme allied commander of NATO in Europe. That's who this guy is.
Ew.
Let's say he has a little bit of political sway, perhaps. More on the way here in moments. Join us via Skype. The Skype username here is lrn.fm. There's more coming up.
This is a life-changing message for anyone with sleep apnea who is on the go and tired of dragging around a big, bulky home CPAP device. MiniCPAP.com now offers a portable device that's as small as a soda can and weighs less than a pound. For even more freedom, you can add a battery that's as tiny as a deck of cards. It's called the Transcend Mini CPAP, and right now you can try it risk-free for 21 days by calling 1-800-939-8536. Transcend is the world's first portable mini CPAP device. It gives you the freedom to sleep in total comfort anywhere you are. Our smallest and most advanced portable design ever, Transcend, is so small and so light you can fit it in your briefcase or purse to use anywhere you go. It's FAA compliant too, so you can even sleep comfortably while flying. Enjoy the freedom to sleep comfortably anywhere. Call MiniCPAP.com now for your 21-day in-home trial. 1-800-939-8536. That's 1-800-939-8536.
There are hundreds of silver products on the market today, but there's nothing like the astonishing health benefits of the multi-patented One Silver Solution. Boost your immune system at a great price with our Silver Solution Liquid, starting at $12.95 a bottle, now available in regular and extra strength. That's half the price of the leading competitors. Call 844-USILVER for your free catalog, or go to onesilversolution.com, onesilversolution.com. There is only one Silver Solution.
All right, so suddenly Walmart, eBay, Amazon, everybody wants to ban the rebel flag. Well, the rebel flag is an important part of American history. The rebel flag is still a long-standing symbol of Southern pride and Southern heritage. So if the big retailers want to play into political correctness and try to deny the history of America, let them. Go to rflags.com. That's R like rebel, R, the letter R. rflags.com. Get your rebel flag before they actually do outlaw the things, huh? rflags.com. That's rflags.com. Go now.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the liberty media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com. You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The Listen Lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
If there was a place that liberty-minded people had been elected to political positions and were rolling back government, would you move there? If freedom lovers had secured a 20% voting bloc and can veto most bad bills, would you move? Well, the time has come to sign the pledge at freestateproject.org. These things have happened in New Hampshire, and you can join us and help. Freestateproject.org. Sign up now at freestateproject.org.
You can watch the LRN Studio Cam and chat with other listeners anytime at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
Back now, more Free Talk Live. You can join us via Skype. Skype username here is lrn.fm. Joining you in the studio, it's Ian tonight.
Renee, Kate.
And King Mark the First.
ProXPN.com/FTL. You go there, get started with ProXPN, and encrypt your internet connection. Protect yourself from prying and spying like your own internet service provider. Probably logging every website you visit, all the search terms you enter. And maybe selling those logs to other corporations for data mining purposes. Maybe they're giving them over to the government for who knows what purpose. ProXPN.com/FTL. You can get started there for free. But when you're ready to upgrade, you can do that too. And use code FTL50 to save 50% off the regular monthly price. When you buy an annual account with code FTL50, you get unlimited bandwidth, servers around the world you can access, you can privately torrent, or get past regionally blocked websites. The app's available for Windows, Mac, iOS, or Android, and Linux. You can go and get started right now for free at proxpn.com/FTL. Use promo code FTL50. You'll get a great discount on privacy that is priceless, and there's a risk-free 7-day money-back guarantee. And plus, ProXPN does not keep records of your online habits. So proxpn.com/FTL. Code is FTL50. General Wesley Clark, the supreme allied commander of Europe, has decided that he knows what's best for you dissidents, you people who don't support the United States, you people who don't appreciate what it is that you have here. This is the best country on the planet, and if you disagree and you speak it out loud, then you belong in a camp.
Don't forget ungrateful. We're ungrateful, too.
Did he mention that?
I don't think so, but that's what I get when I argue with flag supporters. You're ungrateful if you don't understand you have so much freedom in this country, blah, blah, blah. You're ungrateful. You're ignorant. Yeah.
Yeah.
Basically,
well, I think that the United States
is Somalia or the camps, buddy. Which one?
Is a better choice than most countries. But there's a lot of evidence that many countries are sort of the United States has been taken over for the greatest country on earth. As far as that goes, I mean, you know, when you start looking at these lists, the United States is never at the top when you're sort of looking at economic freedom, social freedoms.
How
press
dare
freedom.
You badmouth our country, Mark? This is the best place in the world. Off to the camps with you.
These are facts. They're not badmouthing.
It's badmouthing to talk about facts like that.
Yeah, you're ignorant.
It doesn't matter how many facts you have, Mark. You need to stick with the program here.
More
and that is
U.S. citizens than ever
blind
giving
worship.
Up their giving up their citizenship in order to go to other countries. And that's
those
that.
Fools.
I still think that for you know the average American, this is the best place to, at least for me, right? Like this is the best place to make money. Now, am I going to retire here? Why would I? Why would I want to retire here in the United States when I can go someplace where my dollar is going to go much farther?
That makes sense.
And
yeah.
As long as I'm safe, what would I care? And there's lots of safe places.
You need more loyalty, Mark. Time for the re-education camps.
Yeah, I need to stay here, spend too much for stuff in my retirement.
And
watch the United States inevitably go downhill. I think it's already hit its peak, personally.
Talking now on Skype to JP, calling from our very own Keene, New Hampshire. Hello, JP.
Hey, how are you?
Welcome, sir. Thanks for calling on Skype tonight here. Skype username's lrn.fm.
I just wanted to touch on the Cantwell comment. I know it was a while ago. But I got my kids, so it's been crazy. I want to point out, like, your good interaction with Peter Bowers, for instance. He was nice that day, but then again...
This is a cop. Peter Bowers is a Keene police officer, and you're referring to the day on which he joined Chalk the Police and chalked a smiley face.
Exactly. And then his turn of events in the last couple weeks, he got arrested in Swansea by the state police for DUI. And lost his license for a year and got suspended. Police accountability, I think, never stops. But in Cantwell's case, you know, his change in good interactions with the police. I mean, Macy is a little bit above the norm when it comes to being social with people. He's really good to talk to. But then again, I've seen him hit young boys if they even show the little bit of contempt in them, you know, finding them in the college neighborhoods. And
a lot of these cops have their issues. I mean, there's no doubt about that. I've been on the streets often enough. You and I are probably two of the heaviest cop blockers in the Keene area, meaning that we're out quite a bit compared to other folks. And so I've seen a lot, too. I've seen some of the more mild, with the police that appear to be more mild and calm, get into a certain mood where they're ready to take somebody out. And
their profession's never going to change my mind about them, though. I'm going to blame every single one of them for every single one of their actions because they're all accountable to one another.
But that's not fair, JP.
I understand his mentality because if you're friends with a gangster, for example, mm-hmm. he's part of a gang that does horrible things to horrible people. Does that mean that the gangster couldn't be a nice guy outside of the gang?
Right.
Not necessarily, but...
But that doesn't mean that the individual gangster is responsible for all of the other people's actions in the gang. I mean, that's ridiculous.
Well, from someone who's been in a gang, if you swear an oath to that gang, it's...
I can tell you society as a whole is just not ready for this idea, right?
Like they're treating people like individuals?
No, treating people like gang members. Like they're ready to say that, look, every one of the Crips is responsible for all the actions of the Crips. They're simply not ready to say that every one of the police is responsible for all the actions of any individual police officer.
Let me clarify that. One oath covers the other. And they're trained, their mentality are trained combatively now. They are combatively trained now. They're trained in a combat-oriented manner, and that combat-oriented manner is to cover the man next to you at all costs. Now, the question I gave him about Peter Bowers, this is Kyle Macy on Saturday during the Chalk the Police event, I asked him, did you talk to, Peter Bowers? Did you say, like, what the hell are you doing? He goes, no, I don't talk to him at all. I don't know what to say to that. And he just got really silent. So they cover for one another no matter what. So I don't trust any of them, even though I have good rapport with a few of them, like Lieutenant.
Well, yeah,
Lieutenant
they're
going to
cover for each other. I mean, look, they're not perfect human beings, just like the rest of us. But I think it's better to have a conversation with them than to not have a conversation with them. And I think it's better to look at them as individuals than to look at them as some sort of mass collective that's somehow responsible
I really do believe they're combat oriented, and that I don't believe belongs in community.
But even in Keene, they're relatively mild compared to some of the police out there.
Well, let me ask you, five, six, seven
years ago, they weren't. I mean, they've been pressed with a bunch of cameras in their face, and they've been held accountable for everything they did the past 3 years. Almost.
I think you would still, even 10 years ago, you'd see that the Keene police are just generally a better bunch, slightly.
But I think
than
they're better
cops.
Like this. But I have a question for you, JP, regarding Pete Bowers. So when this happened, for one, I think that this is a testimony to the state police and them doing their job. They pull over a police officer, they give him a DUI.
Yeah, he didn't get professional courtesy that night. That's certainly true.
They gave that.
He did in the court. He did in the court, though. I mean, he was tried, and his arraignment happened in like a week. And that wouldn't happen to me and you.
Okay. I'll give you that.
But I don't know what the sentence was or anything like that.
Right. Did you follow the result? Do you know what the sentence was?
Yes, it was. He lost his license for a year. He has to go to a drug and alcohol program and a drive-in program.
Sounds fairly typical.
Yeah, that sounds typical.
Sounds pretty normal. Now, let me ask you this. I'm going to make you the chief of police.
I would never do it.
Well, the job pays good. I'm going to make you the chief of police. Are you going to fire this officer who's well-trained, right? He's gotten all the training and all that stuff. You need people to drive desks in every department. And, you know, when he's... It, just because he doesn't have a driver's license for the next year doesn't necessarily mean he can't do his job. So are you going to fire this well-trained officer who has years of experience and has exhibited, you know, at this point, a lapse in judgment as far as driving drunk, but, you know, nothing really else?
Yes.
Well, I would, because I know Peter Bowers has done more stuff than that. Going on my personal knowledge about the guy, he's fairly useless and doesn't really act upon anything.
Total jerk.
Unless he's fit. But anyways, if I was chief of police, I would first stop picking on college kids and making $15,000 a month off the poor children.
Yep. And that's one of the things we talked with Kyle Macy about. And, you know,
their parents are status. You get the government you deserve. They're not fighting their tickets.
What are you saying that for?
Because they're making $15,000 or whatever on these college kids. So what?
What do you mean, so what?
They don't have any, they don't care anything about us.
They shouldn't be enforcing. Now, if you match
So hold on, JP. Who's they don't care anything about us? Who's they?
The college students, in many cases, think that the free Keeners are horrible people.
Oh, no. Actually, in many cases, they love Cop Block. In fact, I don't know how many of them know about Keen or Free Keen, but Cop Block does a lot of outreach. Yeah, JP, you go ahead, Mark. Go downtown with JP. Take a night off from the family and go downtown with JP on a Friday night once college kicks off in early September, and you will see people loving JP.
I go in regularly to the parties and kind of cop lock undercover.
He is a hero to these young people, and it's because he's done a lot of outreach to them.
Well, I would have I was almost going to write a letter to the editor encouraging that Pete Bowers be kept on because I think that you know, his training's worth something.
JP, good call tonight, man. Thanks for making it here on Skype only night. Skype username's lrn.fm if you want to join us. Coming up in hour number 3, it's Free Talk Live.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust, who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom. And with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
You know what rubs millions of people the wrong way? Their thighs.
Shaq talks Gold Bond Friction Defense.
Skin friction is quite an affliction. On your legs, arms, whether you're running a 5K or just running upstairs.
And Gold Bond Friction Defense is...
soothing.
Indeed. It's non-greasy, moisturizes, and helps like nobody's business.
Because your thighs rubbing together is nobody's business.
Gold Bond Friction Defense. Defense starts now.
Your thighs will thank you.
Oh boy.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Boost Kit Essentials Nutritionally Complete Drink, providing your picky eater with essential nutrition and great taste in one drink. Visit us at kitessentials.com. To make sure your kids eat healthy, follow the 5-a-day plan. Serve 3 servings of vegetables and 2 servings of fruit daily. Remember, a serving could just mean a piece of fruit or a half cup of veggies. If your kids are picky eaters, ask a nutritionist about other sources. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number 3 is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Monday, July 20th, 2015. Silver is trading at $14.80 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,114 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $278. Antiwar.com reports as fighting continues between Yemen's Shiite Houthis and the pro-Saudi faction loyal to former President Hadi, civilians in the port city of Aden remain caught in the middle, paying a deadly price in the drawn-out war. Yesterday, health officials in Aden reported 57 civilians killed and 215 others wounded in heavy Houthi shelling of the Dar Saad neighborhood, a strategically important residential neighborhood in northern Yemen. The Houthis are aiming to reclaim the city after losing much of it last week. Hadi forces are said to be using Dar Saad as a staging ground for their offensive against surrounding Houthi areas, and the shelling was aimed at halting their advance, though the shelling was also said to be relatively random and took a big civilian toll. This has been the case in fighting and strikes all across Yemen since the Saudi war began in March, and the civilian death toll, which crossed 1,500 last week, is rapidly approaching the 2,000 mark over the 3-month period.
For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. UPI reports German Chancellor Angela Merkel, who has been at the front and center for weeks in the bailout negotiations for Greece, said Sunday that her government is willing to consider further measures to relieve Athens' debt health. Speaking to German television, Merkel said that there are several options on the table to assist Prime Minister Alexis Tsipras's government as it struggles to repay loans and eliminate debt. However, she stipulated that would only be possible once the details of the Greek economic reforms are worked out. Merkel told Germany's ARD TV, "Greece has already been given relief. We had a voluntary haircut among the private creditors, and we then extended maturities once and reduced interest rates," adding, "We can talk now about such possibilities again once the first successful review of the program to be negotiated has been completed, then exactly this question will be discussed. Not now, but then." Merkel, though, rejected any idea that officials will consider simply writing off any of Greece's debt. The German government has been closely monitoring the situation because it, as well as other members of the European Union, would be affected should Greece be expelled from the Eurozone. Merkel's remarks Sunday highlight the country's willingness to keep Athens from sliding into a fiscal abyss, while emphasizing Tsipras's government would not simply be given a clean slate without earning it.
You can support FPP Radio by joining the Fans Program. Fans are friends, allies, and Numeri supporters. You can join the Fans Program for as little as $3 per month or any amount of Bitcoin per month, thanks to the recurring payment options provided by Coinbase. To learn more or to join the Fans Program, visit fans.fppradio.com.
Reuters reports firefighters in Southern California, aided by an unusually long burst of rainfall, have dug containment lines around 60% of a brush fire that torched 20 vehicles and destroyed 11 homes and outbuildings. The U.S. Forest Service said on Sunday the wildfire, which broke out on Friday afternoon in the drought-parched foothills of San Bernardino County, grew from 500 acres to 3,500 acres in a matter of hours. U.S. Forest spokeswoman Lynn Silliette said it held that footprint through Sunday, dampened by a day of light rainfall on Saturday. Fire crews were hoping for more rainfall as they worked to expand the containment lines around the rest of the fire perimeter. Officials lifted all evacuation orders and road closures on Saturday evening, and people were returning to the communities of Baldy Mesa and Oak Hills, California. On Friday, the blaze ripped down a portion of Interstate 15 that links Southern California and Las Vegas, forcing 60 drivers to abandon their cars and scramble to safety. 18 cars and two tractor trailers were destroyed, along with 11 homes and outbuildings. A separate 200-acre wildfire northwest of San Bernardino, which triggered evacuations of several campgrounds on Saturday, was 40% contained, and evacuation orders had been lifted on Sunday. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Seniors thunder into a local high school parking lot like coalition forces entering Baghdad. A substitute teacher just needs to make it to her car before breaking down in tears. And a college freshman tells his roommate there's no need to hide his masturbation from him. And now a week in review that truly requires no introduction. The nation's students announced this week that they have reluctantly agreed to give the American education system yet another chance, saying they hope educators keep their promises of smaller class size, better school supplies, and intensified efforts to raise the country's international math ranking. The nation's students vowed to give the education system one more shot, despite claiming to have been burned many, many times in the past. In other news, a man overcomes alcoholism without the help of Jesus, and an outcast student and a lonely teacher have begun a somewhat endearing sexual relationship. And that was a free lesson in top-shelf journalism. For more news, videos, and reminders of your insignificance, visit theonion.com/newsbeat.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. We're launching into the third hour here. There's enough time for you, plenty of it actually, for you to join us here and talk about whatever you want. Normally we give out toll-free numbers. Tonight that won't be happening because we're doing a little experimental radio. We are doing Skype only tonight. And so if you want to join us, the Skype username is lrn.fm. I've had a handful of contact requests today, so that's a good thing. And that was sort of my intention behind doing this, was to see how it worked out. And secondly, to encourage more people to download and install Skype if you plan on calling the show, because you'll sound better. And if you sound better, it's just an easier experience for me as the host of the show and you as the listener as well. So give us a call on Skype. Skype username's lrn.fm. You can talk about what you want. We've had a couple of generals and some of their commentary tonight. We've been discussing one general who's not such a nice guy, is saying that people who are disloyal to the United States, people who are essentially dissenters, radicalized individuals, should be rounded up and put into camps until the war is over. And by the war, he means the war on terrorism, which, of course, won't ever be over if this government gets its way. Terrorism is this nebulous concept. It's an idea. You know, you can't, it's like the war on drugs. The war on drugs is a war on a physical product that is never going to go away, no matter how many people you put in a jail cell. And the war on terrorism is a war against an idea that the people who are among the ranks of the so-called terrorists are never going to go away, because for every person you put in a prison cell or whose life you extinguish for so-called terrorism, you likely will create new terrorists, which is what the other general was sort of suggesting by saying that the drone strikes that are so popular in the American military right now are actually, point of fact, creating more terrorists than they're destroying. Oh, sorry about that, Mark. Try that one more time. It's Mark, Ian, and Renee in the studio here.
Retired Army General Mike Flynn, who is a former DIA, that's Defense Intelligence Agency, and also he asserts that the U.S. invasion of Iraq helped create the Islamic State and that U.S. soldiers involved in torturing detainees should be held legally accountable for their actions. These same things seem like reasonable things to say, but they're radical in today's culture for whatever reason.
So we've talked about all of that, plus the police. Some commentary a few moments ago from JP, who is one of the cop block activists here in Keene. So you're welcome to join us here and comment on any of that, or bring up whatever's on your mind. Let's go to Dave in Montana via Skype at Skype username lrn.fm. Hello, Dave.
Hey, yo, what's up? That was fast, man. You almost caught me off guard.
It's that easy to get on the air on national radio. People don't understand that. But look, this is an open phone show.
Especially on Skype night, right?
Here's the secret. Well, some nights our regular phones are dead, too. It just depends. You know, you never know what people respond to. I mean, sometimes they find the conversation interesting and they don't want to comment on it. So you never know why people will comment or when they will comment. So I just appreciate it when folks do. But Dave is here with us, who actually used to be a phone caller, and he transitioned to Skype actually probably more than a year ago at this point. And it's been great because you sound awesome on Skype, Dave in Montana. Go ahead with your thoughts tonight.
Well, thank you there, Ian. Bush said that, I remember they asked him, how long are we going to be at this terrorist war? He said, maybe 2 years, maybe 10, maybe 12, maybe 100. He said, yeah, maybe 100 years, man. That's what these people are thinking about. You know, this guy Clark should be arrested, man. He sounds un-American to the max. He sounds worse than the guys in Russia during the revolution over there when they were like offing five people at a time in firing squads. That's what he wants, this guy.
He said, just to recap for our listeners just tuning in, one of the things he said here is quoted over at the Infowars.com, quote, in World War II, if someone supported Nazi Germany at the expense of the United States, we didn't say that was freedom of speech. We put them in a camp. They were prisoners of war, said Clark. Not impressive, huh, Dave in Montana?
Not at all. Not at all, man. This terrorism could be laid on anybody for anything, man. That's not right. That ain't American at all.
Yeah, I'm glad you brought that up, too, because we've had people accused of terrorism for doing things like posting on Facebook. It's ridiculous.
Yeah, they use it for anything now. It's a front. It's a put-on. Eminence front, man. The big put-on, man. They're trying to put on a big straight jacket on everybody and drag us into this new world order. I don't want to use that because it sounds old and faded out, but they got some kind of deal that they're doing right now amongst all the countries, and they want us all spending the same money, doing business at the same bank, doing this usury business to make us all voluntary indentured servants forever.
They certainly do want people in debt, because it's a lot easier to control people when they are in debt to the system. There's no doubt about that. Dave, anything else you want to share? Go ahead.
And it sounds like if you don't want to go along with this debt system, they want to put you in a camp. That is un-American.
Yeah, and this is just the tip of the iceberg. I mean, you've got this guy admitting on national television that he wants to put people who are disloyal to the United States. Those are his words.
We're allowed to be disloyal to the United States.
Sure you are.
That's what's
in a camp.
So great about the United
They're going to let you have your
the
opinion.
The United States was created by a group of people that were disloyal to their government.
Right. And we made it so in our Declaration of Independence. And sometimes you got to rip down the government because it got too strong. It says it right in there, man.
That's right. It's
kind of like that.
Hopefully people will rip it down mentally and destroy the idea of their state in their minds, but not use actual violence, because that's the state's tool. That's what they use to try to change things.
We use their litigation of violence, their paper violence.
Dave, thank you for the call tonight, man. I appreciate you dialing in here on Skype tonight. Skype username, lrn.fm. You can sound just as good as Dave almost all the time on Skype. It's great.
If George Bush said that the war on terrorism could go on for 100 years, I don't know the quote, but let's just take it as fact. I just wonder what the United States is going to look like in 100 years.
It's hard to imagine that.
I don't want to find out.
My prognostication, no better than anybody else's, but the debt that they're currently carrying, I mean, does anyone believe that that's going to get paid down?
No, of course. I mean, who could possibly believe that?
What's that mean?
Not even the politicians could believe that.
What does it mean for the U.S. government? What's it going to look
like?
The
end, hopefully, within 100 years. I don't think it'll make it that long.
Are the states going to continue on? Will they couple up in different ways? Because, I mean, there's a lot of states that have a lot of things in common. I mean, you just take a look at New Jersey and New York and these blue states. Why should they be led by a Republican president? And the red states, why should they be led by a Democratic president? None of these things really make sense.
Just the way it's always been in our lifetime. It's time for that to change.
Just stuff written down on paper.
So join us here, not toll-free, but not at a toll-free number. It's still toll-free on Skype, which is one of the great things about Skype. I mean, again, I'm no fan of Microsoft's product here, but it is the one that is chosen by a lot of people. So that's why we chose it. And you can get on tonight by using calling username lrn.fm. Hey, there's other news, Mark, and you and I both brought this story in about women being used by the LAPD to entrap Uber drivers.
Oh, boy.
So, story from thefreethoughtproject.com. An innocent woman in need frantically flags you down, begging you for a ride. Despite not going through the Uber app, she tells you she's in a hurry. And she asks you to book the ride on your own phone and then begs you to drive across the street over to her friend. When you comply, if you are one of these Uber or Lyft drivers, these rideshare folks, all of a sudden you're surrounded by a gang of cops who accuse you of acting as a bandit cab driver, someone who takes money under the table for rides rather than funneling cash through Uber and, in turn, the state's taxing authorities. Then you're placed under arrest and your car is impounded. Now, Renee, you've given a ride or two to people for some cash in your day. How would you feel about being arrested for doing somebody a favor?
That would be ridiculous. What if I didn't charge them? Because that's probably what I would do.
Well, that's a good point. Yeah, if you don't charge them, then you're probably going to be okay. We'll continue, though, and tell you more about what's happening out there. There are guys driving Uber cabs who have gotten caught in this very sting operation. In the Northeast in New York, they're called jitney cabs or gypsy cabs.
Gypsy. Yeah.
Apparently, they're called bandit cabs out in L.A. More coming up on Free Talk Live.
Attention business owners. Do you know the three most critical letters in business? CEO?
MBA?
Nope. Here's a hint. These three little letters can make the difference between making a fortune and losing everything.
ROI?
The answer is INC, as in incorporation. Because if you're not incorporated in someone sues your business, you can lose it all. Your home, your car, even your life savings. That's why Incorporate.com is now giving away a free incorporation guide to all business owners, so you can incorporate in just 10 minutes. Protect your home. Protect your car. Protect your life savings. Call 1-800-941-1029 for your free 10-minute incorporation guide from Incorporate.com. They don't provide legal or financial advice. They just make incorporating or forming an LLC quick and easy. Get the three little letters that can mean the difference between making a fortune and losing everything. For your free guide, call 1-800-941-1029. That's 1-800-941-1029.
Is negative content or comments on the web affecting your personal or professional reputation? Unfavorable comments, embarrassing pictures, videos, legal documents, and bad tweets can ruin your personal life, your career, or your business. It happens a lot, and it's just not fair. But what can you do? Reputation.com can protect your good name. Get a free consultation now at 800-831-0771. That's 800-831-0771. Call right now for a free expert reputation analysis. It's easy to squash the unfair attacks with our patented system, and the analysis is absolutely free. Make the best things about you jump out in searches. Protect your personal and professional reputation, your business, and your income. Get your free reputation analysis from Reputation.com right now. Call 800-831-0771. 800-831-0771. 800-831-0771.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies!
Jesus.
On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, the Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. Woo! That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
LRN.fm is proud to announce our official listening apps for Android and iOS devices. Now you can easily tune into our streams anywhere, anytime on your smartphone or tablet. Just visit apps.lrn.fm or search for LRN.fm in the Android or Apple app stores. Please download, rate it 5 stars, then share the link on social media, and let your friends and family know how you're listening to LRN.fm. Download it now, free, at apps.lrn.fm. That's apps.lrn.fm.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateur, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolfe. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
You're listening to the best liberty-oriented audio streamed around the clock, on the air, and online. This is the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.fm.
We're back now. More Free Talk Live, allowing you to join us via Skype tonight. We're going to go back to phone calls tomorrow, and we'll still, you know, have the toll-free lines.
Just trying something out.
Just trying something new here. So Skype only tonight. Now, we always have Skype as well, so you always have that as an option. And I have to say, I prefer the Skype sound. I mean, it's got a higher quality. The old phone network, even if you're on a new cell phone, if you're using the phone system to call, it downgrades your call quality. Your phone, your cell phone, if you've got a smartphone, it's capable of high-quality audio. But using it to call a phone number will give you low-quality audio. So if you actually use Skype on your phone, you'll get an upgrade in your call quality, and that's a good thing for radio. So Skype in, username lrn.fm. Tonight, with you in studio, it's Ian.
Renee.
And King Mark the First.
Renee's here, courtesy of the Seditious Sirens. We've been explaining to you what's going on in Los Angeles in yet another attack on these poor Uber drivers. These guys just want to make a little bit of money. A lot of these guys are driving, gals as well, people driving Uber cabs. They're doing it as a part-time gig. They're doing it to fill in the gaps between...
It's not like the economy's real great, people, you know?
Right. People need work, and some people are doing Uber full-time, and they're making it work very, very well. Others are just out there on the weekends or, you know, whenever it is that they have a day off. Because as an Uber or Lyft driver in one of these ride-sharing services, you get to decide your hours. That's because you're not an employee of Uber. You just sort of log into the app, and then it starts making you available for rides, and then people can hire you. I mean, it's that simple.
Yeah, and, you know, I've just seen another celebration that some other town has raised its minimum wage to something over 10 bucks, whatever it is. I'm not entirely sure. And what you have to ask yourself in this circumstance is what does this mean for the young people in that particular city? This isn't a town, by the way. This is a city. I don't remember which one it was.
San Francisco's up to 15.
Yeah, whatever. How are young people going to get jobs in this area? Look, I have never had a minimum wage job when I was the sort of main breadwinner, right? And this is the vast majority of people who make minimum wage. This is the case, right? They live at home or whatever. If they can't make it out of minimum wage, I don't really have a solution for that. But if people are 25, 30 years old making minimum wage, they're pricing out. That it just goes to show that they're pricing out the competition, which is the young people. The question is, as a business person, who would you rather have? Would you rather have a 15-year-old, all things being equal, or a 30-year-old? And if the 30-year-olds are taking the minimum wage job from 15-year-olds, that means that the value of 15-year-old labor has somehow diminished in a marketplace. And sometimes that happens. Supply and demand is that way. Prices fluctuate, they go up and they go down. And many people just don't want to believe, for whatever reason, that the value of labor could ever possibly diminish in the marketplace. But it does. And so how do young people get trained in doing work? Because that's what a minimum wage job is. It is a training job for your next higher wage job. And they're being priced out. They never get an opportunity. They're going to be 22, 23 years old. Well, go to college, kid. Get yourself a big, fat, giant debt.
And yeah, then, great. Go to college, then drive an Uber cab afterwards, right?
Right. And well, now they can't do that either.
Yeah. At least not in Los Angeles. There are some cities that are friendlier to these ride-sharing services than others.
LA is pretty friendly. They just want you to not pick people up without their ride. You got to read this story. Read the story.
Well, no. I mean, I know what this – I will continue. It's a very short piece, actually, over at the Free Thought Project. So what you've got going on is there are police officers, undercover females, who are essentially on the side of the road waving down Uber drivers and then asking the driver to do them a favor and take them to their friend. They're in a hurry.
They didn't cross the street.
They didn't have time to pull up the app. And so then when the driver, as a nice person, does what he's requested to
do. They also ask the driver to pull it up on their app.
Which doesn't make sense.
I don't know what it means either. But it doesn't make a difference.
I don't think as an Uber driver you can hire yourself. That doesn't make sense.
It doesn't make any sense either. Right. But if somebody's asking for a ride, and that's that, right?
And then they're arrested, surrounded by a gang of cops, as explained here at thefreethoughtproject.com. It is the tactic that the LAPD has been using to bust unsuspecting Uber drivers on petty statute violations. Drivers are speaking out now. Three of them are saying they were entrapped by the scheme this past Friday. Bluntly, I think it's cruel, said one of the victims, Michael Chadwick. All the men say they've never asked people if they needed rides in the past and pointed out they have near-perfect customer ratings. Nonetheless, they've been made to feel like criminals. And why should you feel like you're a criminal if you're doing someone a favor, if you're helping somebody out, helping someone to get from point A to point B?
Because everybody in America is now a criminal. That's the reason. You are a criminal. There are so many crimes, and they can enforce them in so many different ways that you are. Every last one of you listening to me is a criminal. To shake your finger at the next guy who happens to get caught is hypocritical.
Doing the right thing is illegal in the United States and a lot of different places. And it's sick. It really is. Going on here, the LA Department of Transportation confirms that they and the LAPD carry out such operations but failed to comment on the cases. For the three men, the next step is to try to get their vehicles back. Oh, yeah. you're getting their cars impounded too.
Yeah, nice.
So not only are they ending up with charges, I don't know if they're criminal or violations or whatever, but they're still charges that they will likely have to pay through the nose for, because I don't imagine these charges are going to be cheap in a place like L.A. You don't go to an L.A. or New York and end up with a, you know, a $5 ticket like you can get for parking wrong in Keene, New Hampshire. So, yeah, not going to be easy for these guys. And there's more details over at the CBS story, which is linked to over at thefreethoughtproject.com. But I think this really puts it out there, really makes it crystal clear. And it reminds me of the stings they were doing in Florida. I remember years ago, there was a story about an elderly gentleman who was sort of flagged down in a parking lot.
At a grocery store. Yep. He's leaving a grocery store. And, of course, they send
out Dixie or whatever.
They send out the hot gals, right? It's hard.
Oh, yeah.
It's hard
college
to tell.
College-age female.
Hot gals, no. Have you noticed this in your life, Renee?
A little bit.
Yeah. She might just use that in her life.
Right.
A little bit.
Like every day.
Yeah.
Right. I mean, it's hard. And so some hot gal says, hey, you want to, can I have a ride?
No. Hey, can I have a ride?
Right. And the answer is going to be, yeah. And then in the case of down in Miami, which you were talking about, yeah. The woman, like, almost bodily forces this guy to take some money from
$5.
Her. Anything, just take some money from me, and then they swoop in and get
right.
him. You know, just
he
some
was a
guy.
Man in his 70s, not even a cabbie. This was before Uber.
Just somebody.
Just some guy who was going to the grocery store, and there's a woman in the parking lot saying, hey,
these
I need to get
these are cops
home.
That have nothing to do. This is a waste of your taxpaying dollar. These are police that are stealing from you. They're going out and wasting the time that you pay them for, $30, $40, $50 an hour. God knows with benefits what these people are getting paid. They are stinking thieves.
Oh, thieves, Mark, you are harassing, you're threatening and intimidating those poor cops. They're just doing their jobs.
They're doing what their bosses are telling them to, and their bosses are wasting our time and money. These police officers should arrest their bosses from stealing from the public. That's what somebody who took an oath to the Constitution would do.
Like they care.
They don't care a flip.
Most of them haven't read it. They've sworn an oath to it. I mean, that's
sure.
still usually a requirement to become a police officer, that you have to swear an oath to the Constitution, but they don't know what it says. There's more on the way. We've got not a toll-free number tonight. You have to call on Skype if you want to join us. The Skype username is lrn.fm. Send a contact request first. You'll be approved, and then it's easy to call from that point forward. We'll continue in moments. This is Free Talk Live. Coming up, more on El Chapo.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
All right, so suddenly Walmart, eBay, Amazon, everybody wants to ban the rebel flag. Well, the rebel flag is an important part of American history. The rebel flag is still a long-standing symbol of Southern pride and Southern heritage. So if the big retailers want to play into political correctness and try to deny the history of America, let them. Go to ourflags.com, that's R like rebel, R, the letter R, ourflags.com. Get your rebel flag before they actually do outlaw the things, huh? Ourflags.com, that's ourflags.com. Go now.
A congressman recently revealed that legislation totaling 2,900 pages and involving more than $1 trillion was available to members of Congress for less than 48 hours to study and consider. That's over 60 pages of legislation per hour. Do you think anyone read the entire bill? I'm Jim Babka with DownsizeDC.org. Consider a proposal buried in a 3,200-page, $388 billion bill, which would have empowered committee chairmen or their agents to examine Americans' tax returns. When this horrible provision came to light, no one claimed to know how it got into the bill. One congressman questioned said, I didn't write it, I didn't approve it, I wasn't even consulted. If your attorney represented you this way, he might be disbarred. But this is how Congress represents you every day. That's why DownsizeDC.org has created the Read the Bills Act. You can force Congress to read their bills before they pass them at DownsizeDC.org.
If you want to move to the free state and you're looking for some real estate.
Oof, I think we've all had enough of that jingle, don't you?
If you're going to invest in property in New Hampshire, it just makes sense to support a Liberty-friendly realtor. Call Mark Warden of Team Porcupine Real Estate for investment property or rentals in the Free State, or visit his website. Come on, you know it.
PorcupineRealEstate.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here, and I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with a chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You're invited to join us here via Skype, a Skype-only night here, just as an experiment, just this one night. You can Skype in at username lrn.fm. And then tomorrow night, we'll bring back the regular toll-free lines and Skype. So you can still Skype tomorrow, too. But, you know, comment on whatever you want. We've been talking about putting dissidents in camps. Not my idea. That's the idea of Wesley Clark, the former Supreme Allied Commander of Europe for NATO and a retired U.S. Army general. He wants to round you up if you are disloyal. Someone who doesn't support the United States in everything they do, all the wars and all the taxes. If you don't love America 110%, you might end up in a camp if this guy gets his way. So that's one of the things we've discussed here tonight, plus the never-ending war on terror and more. There's also, at the beginning of the show, the Euchre crackdown going on in Indiana, where they're targeting elderly people who are playing a card game for prizes. They're saying that's illegal. Comment on any of that or whatever's on your mind at the Skype username, lrn.fm. Also, Uber drivers under attack in Los Angeles. Uber's under attack everywhere. There's a headline from a few weeks ago in New York City about how there were nearly 500 Uber cars that had been impounded in New York City. Think about that. Think about the numbers involved in that. 500 cars. And this was, it was like 496. And this was several weeks ago, so I imagine they've impounded their 500th car by now. 500 people's livelihoods ruined, because that's what we're talking about here. The Uber drivers, this is how a lot of them, it's full-time income for them. They're out there making
even
money.
Even it's part-time income. They're not out there driving because they're rich.
Well, right.
Right?
Even,
they
right.
just want to meet people.
Even, right. Even if it's part-time income, they probably need the car for something else. So, you know, if they're going to work during the week and then doing a little bit of Uber driving on the weekend, then boop, they get popped. Then their car's gone, and that's going to make things very inconvenient for life. That is a huge contributor to inconvenience and difficulty in people's lives, not having a car.
Getting your car towed totally sucks.
In general, or by the police?
Well, both. I've had it done by both, and it sucks. One time, I was left out on the side of the road. It was about 3 in the morning, and it was freezing, and they towed my boyfriend's car because he didn't have insurance and we were in Vermont.
Mm.
God forbid. So, sure enough, we were left standing there. She didn't care. She got in her car and drove away and left us there. And I hitchhiked back to New Hampshire.
So you have to have, so New Hampshire is one of the, I think, is it the only state where you don't have to have car insurance or one of, it's certainly one of the only
I
ones.
Believe so, at least in this immediate area.
So if you want to leave New Hampshire, you have to have car insurance. You can't just say, oh, well, I'm from New Hampshire. Sorry, no car insurance required there.
Yep. Got to have insurance. And you do have to have insurance if you are under 20 or 18.
Probably 25 or whatever, right? Because, oh, wait, no. Wait, you can't even. Can you get into, what's the rule about being 25? Is only you can't rent a car?
I think so, yeah.
Yeah, I think that's 25 and under, yeah.
All right, so whether you want to comment on Uber or whatever, El Chapo is back in the news. Maybe you recall El Chapo. He's the guy who escaped. There was a tunneled under his prison. He escaped through this tunnel. And at first I'd heard that he was on a motorbike. Then I heard that he wasn't. Then I saw a picture of the motorbike. I'm pretty sure they did leave a motorbike down there for him to ride in these tunnels. He rode to the underground of a house that was like within a mile on
this
tunnel.
They dug a mile, a tunnel? Mile-long tunnel?
I think they did. I mean, we're talking about the Sinaloa drug cartel here, Mark. These are people who are well-funded individuals. Mr. El Chapo is one of the world's probably most wealthy people. If you know, although it would be hard to really tally up the amount of money he controls, you don't get to be the head of the Sinaloa drug cartel.
He put a $100 million bounty on Trump's head today.
Did he really?
I believe that's the number.
Yeah. Check that story out, because I hadn't even heard of that one yet. This comes back to the spat that he had between Donald Trump and he. After he got out, Donald Trump tweeted that he was gonna would kick his ASS if he saw El Chapo or whatever, which is, you know, just said that he would kick his butt. And so El Chapo tweeted back at him through his son's Twitter account. I guess it's an El Chapo Twitter account, but his son administers it for him. And he basically tweeted back a homosexual slur at Donald Trump and said, essentially, you don't mess with El Chapo. So, well, you know, it should be very interesting to see what happens here. And Mark will give us more details.
Chapo
about
puts
that.
$100 million bounty for Donald Trump dead.
Wow.
Or alive.
Or alive.
Sorry, they put that first. Oh, God.
You know, I don't relish any violence happening to anybody, but, you know, you probably don't want to threaten the head of the Sinaloa drug cartel.
Yeah, idiot.
Not doing that.
I mean, just saying there, Don, or whatever your friends call you.
Donnie.
The Don.
Hair.
What do they call him? Anyway.
Fuzzy.
The Dons.
Culiacan, Mexico. When Jose Antonio Sevilla and his three brothers learned that the notorious drug trafficker known as El Chapo had escaped from prison, they jumped out of their chairs and shouted with glee. The story from the New York Times, El Chapo got out. He's the greatest of them all, said Mr. Sevilla, age 19, a self-professed fan of the drug kingpin, whose full name is Joaquin Guzman Lorera. He was famous before, but now he's even more famous, said Sevilla. He's an auto mechanic, Sevilla is, who was excited that he attended a march through, so excited rather, that he attended a march through the streets of Culiacan, the capital of Mr. Guzman's home state, this week to celebrate. He carried a sign that a woman gave him, which read, El Chapo is more of a president than Peña Nieto, a reference to Mexico's president, Enrique Peña Nieto. Here in Sinaloa State, where Mr. Guzman was born, and even in other parts of Mexico, the drug trafficker's stunning escape through a hidden tunnel under what was supposed to be the country's most secure prison has enhanced his status as an outlaw folk hero. There are few illusions about the damage Mr. Guzman has done. American officials accuse him of contributing to the death and destruction of millions of lives across the globe through drug addiction, violence, and corruption. Yet for many Americans, he is an unusual combination of Robin Hood and billionaire, a source of mirth, grudging respect, and even outright reverence because of his repeated ability to outfox the country's deeply unpopular government. He fought the law, and he won. He beat what many Mexicans see as a corrupt and feckless governing class. And Mexico, just like America, loves an outlaw. Why do people admire him, says Adrian Cabrera, a blogger in Culiacan wearing a black t-shirt with a picture of El Chapo? Because he's a living legend. He's like Al Capone. He's like Lucky Luciano, like Tony Soprano, like Scarface. He's like a character on a television show, except that he's alive.
He's real.
Who is that guy, that gangster that recently got arrested from New York where they, you know, in his neighborhood, they loved him and they...
Recently, huh?
Yeah, not recently in the last year, but recently in the last 10 years.
I don't know.
And he'd like thrown block parties and these people seem to really like him. I'm not saying that... I'm saying here that imagine how poorly your government represents you if you support a gangster.
Actually, maybe it wasn't a mile long tunnel. It could be only 30 feet. I'm not really sure about that. Anyway, going on here. In the cultural center in...
I do think the best prison escape vehicle is sort of an enduro motorcycle.
Yeah.
Something that can go on both the land and, something
and
both
off-road.
The road. On and off-road, I guess is what I'm trying to say. And that would give you a real advantage over pretty much every other vehicle out there.
Except for the helicopter, yeah.
Yeah, you're not going to be a helicopter, but at the very least, you can get into the woods where the helicopter can't necessarily see you.
That's true. I don't know how much woods was around this particular prison in Mexico.
Nor do I.
In the cultural center in Badiraguato, the main town in the municipality where Guzman grew up, there's a list of the notable people born in the area, including a general in the Mexican Revolution, a journalist, lawyer, and congressman. There's no mention of its most famous son, Mr. Guzman, but the center's director of events argues that El Chapo deserves to be on the list, too. Said events director Guadalupe Olivas, he said, quote, "He has never had any problems with people here. He was poor, and now he has lots of money and lots of power." Unquote. Mr. Guzman was born in the 1950s in a remote hamlet in the lumpy green mountains that are the backdrop to the state capital in an area known as the Golden Triangle, which today is Mexico's prime marijuana growing region. We'll tell you more about El Chapo's sort of folk hero status in a lot of Mexico. We'll come back with that here in moments. There have been people who've said that the drug lords are actually better at protecting the people of many parts of Mexico than the government themselves. So, to some extent, they've earned this status, from what I've heard, at least. You can share your thoughts. Maybe you're down there. Call in on Skype at lrn.fm.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to purse.freetalklive.com and open an account. Do this right now, don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to purse.freetalklive.com right now and get signed up and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 25% off of everything on Amazon through purse.freetalklive.com. It's purse.freetalklive.com.
Hi, this is Ted Anderson. Have you ever wondered why banks, stockbrokers, investment advisors won't talk about gold IRAs? They've been available since 1986, yet the financial industry won't recognize the value of gold for your retirement. Gold has outperformed paper investments, yet no word about IRAs. If you would like to have gold for your retirement, call 800-686-2237. Don't get left behind by rising inflation and low returns. Call 800-686-2237. Secure your future and call 1-800-686-2237.
Affordable health insurance was the promise of Obamacare, but for many, the government mandate caused more problems than it solved. And I want to tell you about a truly affordable alternative, Liberty HealthShare. Liberty HealthShare bypasses doctor and hospital panels, giving you the freedom to choose. 100% coverage up to $1 million per year per occurrence, which includes dental, vision, pharmacy, and holistic care. Call 1-800-714-6993. 1-800-714-6993. 1-800-714-6993 today.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. Physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com. If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
Are you tired of governments murdering people around the world? Stop using their money. There is an alternative. Bitcoin is a stateless, free market, non-political currency. Bitcoin cannot be inflated or controlled by any government. By using their money, you are helping the state. You have an incredible alternative available now. Learn it, use it, spread it. Get started with Bitcoin at weusecoins.com. That's weusecoins.com.
Do you love Twitter? Make sure you favorite the LRN.FM Twitter account so you can receive our tweets at twitter.lrn.fm. That's twitter.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. Whether you want to talk about the minimum wage or this crazy idea to inter people into camps who are disagreeing with the existence of the government. You don't like the United States government? Well, former General Wesley Clark says you belong in a camp for as long as the war on terror is going on. And then
forever. Forever.
Yeah, basically forever. We're also talking about El Chapo. He is once again in the news in a story on the New York Times explaining why he's seen as kind of a folk hero. And by the way, I got some numbers mixed up. I had heard it was nearly a mile-long tunnel, and then I saw a number about 30 feet. Okay, so apparently the 30 feet is how deep the tunnel was. So it was 30 feet down and then nearly a mile long. It's actually 0.7 miles, the New York Times.
About a kilometer.
Yeah, it has an infographic here. It's the distance between the Altiplano Maximum Security Prison.
Here's a real opportunity.
And a construction site.
To go ahead and tell the American public what a kilometer is. You know, like, let's just go ahead and say this is a kilometer, about a kilometer long.
Is that a 0.7 miles? Is it about a kilometer?
It is. And instead, they say that, you know, they just feed right into. I mean, at the very least, you can put in parentheses 0.7 miles. No, you tell them it's a kilometer because it's a kilometer, okay? And then you tell them that's 0.7 miles for those of you that just didn't get it at school. I get it, but I mean, man, oh man, we won't transition. This is from Mexico. Don't they tell distance in kilometers down there?
I suspect they do. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that the U.S. is like one of the only places in the world that uses miles, right?
Probably I think Belize.
Is that right?
Yeah.
So more on Guzman, Mr. Guzman, a.k.a. El Chapo. He is the guy who escaped from maximum security prison because of this tunnel that had been built for his escape. And apparently there were a number of prison guards who were in on this. And now they're, of course, the state is going after those people. But El Chapo is still on the loose. Nobody knows where he's hiding out. In fact, this is the second time that he has actually escaped from prison. And many people in his home state of Sinaloa, he's the head of the Sinaloa cartel, and that's also the name of the state in which he was birthed, think that he's kind of like a hero. One guy says he's like a character on a television show, except that he's alive and he's real, and he really is threatening Donald Trump with a $100 million bounty on his head, dead or alive.
Yeah, I don't support this in any way, shape, or form, but I think it's interesting to sort of look at this this escape. It's interesting to look at how people in his area feel about him. I think this whole thing between Trump and him is quite frankly hilarious.
Over the years, Mr. Guzman rose through the ranks of Mexican drug gangs until he came to head the largest of them all, the Sinaloa Cartel, named for the state, where he continued to spend a good deal of time even as a wanted man. When he was arrested last year, the authorities found him at the Sinaloan beach resort of Mazatlan. Mr. Guzman operates a vast international organization. Forbes magazine has included him in its list of the world's richest people with an estimated net worth of more than $1 billion.
He escaped from...
I'm kind of surprised about the his escape and everything, that people are so loyal to him that they help him escape. Because, I mean, I would think that if you're like sort of the, you know, the second in commands, the several second in commands, mm-hmm. and this guy goes
that
to
you'd
prison,
relish him going away.
You'd be like, huh, looks like I just got a lot richer. Better make sure that he never gets out.
Yeah, but you don't want to... Okay, there's different reasons why that they would want to help him. Okay, number one is that there's some, honor in this particular trade. And if Guzman gave you the position of power in this gang that has made you into a wealthy lieutenant, then maybe you appreciate that and you will stay loyal to him. Further, you probably know you don't want to cross Guzman, in even though he's in prison. Odds are good that if, you know, it's found out that his loyal left-hand lieutenant has, gleefully accepted the role of being the boss man and is relishing it and saying bad things about El Chapo, then some of the people who are still loyal to El Chapo might just decide to take him out at the order or the behest of El Chapo.
Right. I mean, there's not going to be just one second-in-command. There's going to be several second-in-commands, and those people are going to be vying for that position. So, and to some extent, by supporting El Chapo, you keep the peace amongst your brethren. Also, it's sort of the prisoner's dilemma. You don't want to be the guy who says, you know what, I'm glad he's gone. I've got a bunch of extra money, when somebody, some other guy who's a second in command, a lieutenant or whatever term we're going to use here, one of those guys says, but I want our great boss back. You don't want to be in that position,
right?
Because,
you could end up with your head cut off.
Yeah, well, so could everybody.
Yeah, exactly. So he has escaped prison once before, by some accounts, by hiding in a laundry cart, and his most recent breakout was highly elaborate. He passed through a sophisticated tunnel about a mile long, one equipped with lights, ventilation, and even a motorcycle on rails to excavate the dirt. It took a lot of intelligence to do that, said Erica Lara, who sells shaved ice in the plaza of Badiraguato. She says, there are powerful people who have to serve their entire sentences, but he escaped two times. Many here said that Mr. Guzman helped residents, often in small ways. A family with a sick member might receive a visitor delivering money for treatment, they said, although none could point to a specific example. And these are the stories you hear about, these drug cartels being better at helping people in their homes, in their hometowns, than the government themselves. And so they build some level of rapport among the average folks, who would then be, of course, more likely to help protect them if necessary. And, you know, you hear all the stories about people getting their heads cut off and put on pikes and, you know, the brutality of the war on drugs. But those usually aren't innocent people who they're targeting. They're targeting people who are members of rival cartels.
There have been some incidences, but, you know, they aren't. In many cases, they're probably not the gang, the local gang. They're the rival gang from some distance away.
Who's targeting innocents to try to, what, make an impression or whatever?
Who knows what they're trying to do? You know, make the local gang look bad.
I bet you 9 times out of 10, if not more often, it's rival drug cartel members that are being targeted in those
attacks. Oh, yeah,
I
would say 9 times out of 10 is probably pretty generous.
So while buying the shaved ice in the Badiraguato Plaza, Amariani Avias, age 20, called Mr. Guzman my hero.
Huh.
Many here say that streets have been paved using money from drug traffickers.
Dude's got $1 billion. I guess he could do that.
But who would build the roads?
Yeah, exactly. Apparently, El Chapo. While Sinaloa is Mexico's tomato-growing capital, the area around Badiraguato has the distinction of being the cradle of the Mexican drug trade. Besides Guzman, several other major traffickers were born here or in the nearby hills. She says, this is the shaved ice girl, says the economy in the region depended on Mr. Guzman, and that people might now get work on land he owns or could grow more marijuana to sell to his organization. Mrs. Avalez said, quote, when they arrested him, people around here had to go back to growing corn.
Note that he's talking about growing marijuana here.
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you want to stop this drug war, there's only one way to do it. You legalize the marijuana growth. Chapo's made his billions of dollars.
You're going to have to legalize
stuff.
Cocaine, too. I mean, he's going to be making lots of money off of lots of drugs, but certainly
it's
good chunk of
it's financed on the back of weed.
It's a huge chunk of it. There's no doubt about that.
It's the first place to start and see what happens.
Aviles says now the corn will turn into marijuana. Experts say drug production does not depend much on whether a single trafficker, no matter how influential, is in or out of jail. Well, of course, because every time you put a drug trafficker in jail, you're just opening up a job opportunity for somebody new. Beyond that, Sinaloa last year ranked second in the government's measure of international homicides per capita at a level more than 2.5 times the national average. Yet many people here said that their state was relatively calm, thanks to Mr. Guzman's influence. Scarlett Lopez, age 22, who works at a finance company in Culiacan, said that while she disapproved of Mr. Guzman's drug trafficking, she was glad he was out of prison, because it meant that even worse drug gangs, the Zetas, for instance, known for cutting off people's heads and other acts of graphic violence, would be less likely to try to encroach on the state. She says, I feel better because we're protected. There are people who are a lot worse. So the fact that El Chapo is out, she says, means that she'll be feeling safer from the
and
other
she disapproves
gangs.
Of his drug dealing.
Yeah. Near a government office building here in the state capital is an elaborate shrine dedicated to a folk saint known as Jesus Malverde. He's often called the narco saint because he's worshipped by many drug traffickers. Malverde is supposedly based on a local man who lived from 1870 to 1909 and was known as a bandit who stole from the rich to give to the poor. He's also worshipped by poor people, farmers, fishermen, and others. This week, a stream of devotees visited the shrine, some lighting candles, some kneeling to pray before a plaster bust of Malverde, portrayed with black hair and mustache, a white Western-style shirt, and black neckerchief. There were flowers on either side, and the air was dense with the smell of hot wax. A statue of the Virgin of Guadalupe stood by the entrance. The walls were covered in plaques left by devotees, thanking Malverde for favors or miracles. The government has offered a reward of $3.8 million for information leading to Guzman's capture, but people visiting the shrine said, what about helping them capture him?
They're not interested.
Nope. They said they would not lend the government a hand. The drug dealers do more for the people than the government does, said Eric Reyes, age 33. We'll post the story. You can read more about El Chapo. He's a hero to a lot of people on our Facebook and our Twitter. Check out Renee at Seditious Sirens on Facebook. See you tomorrow.
Do you know the difference between erudite and pedantic? If you do, you're probably pedantic. But seriously, a surprising number of erudite people mispronounce erudite, which has 3 syllables, not 4. Say erudite, not erudite. Because you are judged by how you speak, you want to avoid common misstatements, especially if you're a job seeker. For instance, do you know the difference between imply and infer? Only a speaker can imply. Only a listener can infer. And when you say you'll be out of pocket, do you mean out of touch? Out of pocket means you're on your own dime, not yet reimbursed. And if anyone ever asks, why do you always answer a question with a question? You should reply, do I do that? Just kidding. From SurvivalSpeech.com, I'm Holland Cook.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. facebook.freetalklive.com.
The live edition of Liberty Conspiracy is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Monday, July 20th, 2015. Silver is trading at $14.80 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,114 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $278. Antiwar.com reports, as fighting continues between Yemen's Shiite Houthis and the pro-Saudi faction loyal to former President Hadi, civilians in the port city of Aden remain caught in the middle, paying a deadly price in the drawn-out war. Yesterday, health officials in Aden reported 57 civilians killed and 215 others wounded in heavy Houthi shelling of the Dar Saad neighborhood, a strategically important residential neighborhood in northern Yemen. The Houthis are aiming to reclaim the city after losing much of it last week. Hadi forces are said to be using Dar Saad as a staging ground for their offensive against surrounding Houthi areas, and the shelling was aimed at halting their advance, though the shelling was also said to be relatively random and took a big civilian toll. This has been the case in fighting and strikes all across Yemen since the Saudi war began in March, and the civilian death toll, which crossed 1,500 last week, is rapidly approaching the 2,000 mark over the three-month period. For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. UPI reports German Chancellor Angela Merkel, who has been at the front and center for weeks in the bailout negotiations for Greece, said Sunday that her government is willing to consider further measures to relieve Athens' debt health. Speaking to German television, Merkel said that there are several options on the table to assist Prime Minister Alexis Tsipras' government as it struggles to repay loans and eliminate debt. However, she stipulated that would only be possible once the details of the Greek economic reforms are worked out. Merkel told Germany's ARD TV, "Greece has already been given relief. We had a voluntary haircut among the private creditors, and we then extended maturities once and reduced interest rates," adding, "We can talk now about such possibilities again once the first successful review of the program to be negotiated has been completed, then exactly this question will be discussed. Not now, but then." Merkel, though, rejected any idea that officials will consider simply writing off any of Greece's debt. The German government has been closely monitoring the situation because it, as well as other members of the European Union, would be affected should Greece be expelled from the Eurozone. Merkel's remarks Sunday highlight the country's willingness to keep Athens from sliding into a fiscal abyss, while emphasizing Tsipras's government would not simply be given a clean slate without earning it.
You can support FPP Radio by joining the Fans Program. Fans are friends, allies, and Numeri supporters. You can join the Fans Program for as little as $3 per month or any amount of Bitcoin per month, thanks to the recurring payment options provided by Coinbase. To learn more or to join the Fans Program, visit fans.fppradio.com.
Reuters reports firefighters in Southern California, aided by an unusually long burst of rainfall, have dug containment lines around 60% of a brush fire that torched 20 vehicles and destroyed 11 homes and outbuildings. The U.S. Forest Service said on Sunday the wildfire, which broke out on Friday afternoon in the drought